know what it meant. IU Kentucky, playing for the Bourbon Barrel. But last year was my first, you know, IU Kentucky. I know those referees had all 22 players nose to nose, and he was yelling at us saying, you know, I'm not gonna have any more of this stuff out here. So it's a heated, intense rivalry, and we'll be getting after them, and I'm sure they'll be cranked up for us.
Well, John, I'm sure we're going to have a lot more of what you just described right there. Well, here are tonight's society keys to the game for Indiana yards plus tonight.
Not only Alex Smith, but I think everybody needs to get involved in this game.
I think Brett Law can come in and contribute also, but 150 yards is a right number.
And secondarily, if they rush well enough, they will have to pass efficiently. And so far, they have done that as a team, 65%. And third of all, that's the big one right there. The kicking game, IU, we think is superior in both departments, and they're going to have to cut down on the turnovers. They fumbled five times and lost four of them. Now, for the University of Kentucky to win, well, they need to get a little confidence and poise. Joe Huff, we think if they're going to get that confidence and poise, they have to do it right off the start of the ball game.
I think they need to come out fired up and show Indiana that they are a good football team.
All right, they need to challenge the secondary of IU because there is some question as to whether IU can handle a good passing team. Kentucky is not that, but they'll have to challenge the secondary. And they are a run domination team. They will have to get their act together in that department too. Well, the captains of these ball clubs are going on to this field. Stinson, Schlegel, Carter, all the rest will be back to bring you the kickoff of IU Kentucky right after this.
Sorry, I didn't mean to.
No, you going like this, and like you were
I was just trying to push it in.
Oh, I know. I didn't know. I was looking at you, and then you wanted me to speak.
That was
thank
good.
You,
it worked well.
That's fine.
Smith's gone.
All right.
Get time ready to play football.
Yes.
Yes, sir. Hey, Chuck, if you can hear me in back there. Mallory has agreed if everything's going smoothly, he'll do something with me just before halftime, so I'll cut out. Okay, IFB-wise, I just wanted to let everybody know. Bye.
Ready to go, ready to go.
Yes, sir. Let's do it.
His headset feels like a football helmet. I'm ready to go out there.
Yeah.
Where's the,
you need a flip?
Yeah, it's right behind here. I just wanted to make sure I knew where the officials were.
Split crew?
Got enough room? All right. Fired up here.
Okay, here we go.
There's the Bourbon Barrel down there.
The UK Athletics Association would like to welcome the golfers who are competing in the United States.
Welcome back to Commonwealth Stadium. The records of these two ball clubs as Kentucky comes onto the field. They will receive to start our ball game tonight. Kentucky 1-1. They won their first game against Louisville, 20-14. We've already mentioned their loss to Florida, 73-7. And IU has won both of its ball games convincingly, 28-3 over Cincinnati, 35-14 over Miami of Ohio, and Wisconsin comes up next week. Keo Sanford and Clyde Rudolph are back. Sanford number 6, Clyde Rudolph number 27. You'll hear a lot of those names tonight. They do a lot of double duty, not only on special teams, but offensively also as wideouts. And kicking off for IU's Hoosiers, Bill Manolopoulos. Joe, we were talking about this before the ball game here. The kicking game is so important. Manolopoulos with the strong leg, all Big Ten. DiGiulio, all Big Ten. And Kentucky has had some problems with their kicking game.
Right, Don. Three phases of the game is the kicking game, offense and defense. And of course, like you said, we had two all Big Ten kickers and we're fortunate to have them.
All right, here's the run up by Manolopoulos. It's a tall boot and it's coming down to Rudolph at the four. 15, 20. Ah, and he's ripped down at the 22-yard line. And making the stop for the Hoosiers will be Matt Surface from Marion, who's Dad Mark, we all know very well, as the head coach at Marion High School. Let's look at the offense. All right, here's Antonio Farrell's going to be your quarterback here tonight. The best runner is Mo Williams. He hasn't run very well yet this year. And Damon Hood is the fullback who has over 1,000 yards. That's the backfield for the University of Kentucky, and we're ready to go here. Let's get back to the live action. O'Farrell, not a really good passing quarterback. You'll see the triple option here a lot tonight. They come out in the I formation, and there's Williams getting the first carry of the night up to the 25-yard line.
Don, Mo Williams set a UK freshman record, 159 yards against Georgia, so we know this guy is very capable to make some trouble back here.
They're a little uptight about the guy. Look here for the offensive line, Askin, Schlarman, Carruthers, Jones, and Purdy. Not a veteran offensive line. Mo Williams, the SEC's leading rusher in 1994. He had almost 1,000 yards last year, 980 yards, but a bit suspect this year, 24 carries, 74 yards. Second down and eight on the 25. The pitch to Williams again. Nice tackle again. And he's knocked down by Warnicki, 17, as he crosses the 25-yard line. So good support from the secondary. Now that's something, Joe, I would think they'd have to watch out for, is getting sucked up by the run.
Yes, Don. Kentucky's out in an I formation, and like what you'll see for Indiana also. You don't want to constrain too much on the running game because it'll suck you up and throw you the deep ball. And of course, Indiana's secondary is quite young right now.
Just underway, first quarter, 13:45 remaining. Third down and six for Kentucky. First possession, the ball's on the 27-yard line. Goody and Ellum's back. The deep safeties for IU. O'Farrell. It was intended for Wyatt, knocked down by Alfonso Thurman, always around the football, number 48.
He had a nice one last week against Miami, and he had that one in his paws again there.
Yeah, a lot of people were getting on Alfonso for saying that he was slow, but he looked pretty quick to me. He got the touchdown.
Well, Bill Mallory said he was glad that Alfonso was slow last week because he took a couple minutes off the clock. That's not quite true.
Nicky Nichols, the man in punting formation at the 12-yard line. And deep for IU is Eddie Beatty. And a block punt picked off by IU. Goody at the 22-yard line, and that's where IU will take over. Well, that's a name that ought to go down in this stadium because father's name played for Kentucky. The Goody name is well known here in Kentucky. Nichols, and it's blocked. I did not see the number. Catch me again on who blocked the ball. I think it was. Well, we'll wait. Let's just wait on this one. Goody blocked it and picked it up. Excellent.
Great opportunity for the Hoosiers right here.
Tremendous opportunity. Well, we were talking before the game that Kentucky had a start quickly. IU's doing just exactly that. There's the man, Smith, down to the 10, the 9-yard line. A big gainer on the first play. Johnson makes the stop. Melvin Johnson, one of the two people they have back defensively, 6'1", 198, and a senior from Cincinnati St. Xavier. Look at it here.
This is exactly what the Hoosiers want to do on their first series. Alex Smith, of course, Kentucky knows they have to stop him. And first down and goal off their first offensive play.
We could have run through that one, Calabro.
I think
enough,
I could have made that.
All what right. Do you think, Huff? Can you run that one?
Okay, that was a big hole.
First and goal from the nine. Lee and Smith in the backfield. And Smith gets the call right up the gut. Touchdown, IU!
Alex Smith on the carry for Indiana.
Well, two plays, and the Hoosiers are in the end zone. And now let's see how Kentucky reacts to this. This is exactly what happened to them in Florida. Alex didn't have too many choices there, did he?
Had a pretty nice hole right the gut.
The offensive line is dominating right now.
Here's another angle of the touchdown run by Alex Smith as the Hoosiers get on the board. Nice cut back there.
And an excellent block, too, on the inside by Chris Lewinsky, number 74, 6'6", 275, a freshman from Sterling Heights, Michigan. All right, 7-0 Indiana, 12:55 left first quarter, and we're back in a minute.
Look who's standing in the stadium and who's not.
Well, that, if you call that a drive, was two plays, 22 yards, took him 26 seconds to do it. A 9-yard touchdown by that man right there, Alex Smith. And his fourth touchdown of the year.
Joe, you were talking about the fact how the kicking game would be a key here, and you right off the bat, it's a huge key.
As I mentioned, kicking is the third phase of the game. It's so important, as you can see, that it resulted in 7 points for the Hoosiers.
Now, lots of times we do forget about the kicking game. You take it as a constant. These guys are so good. All right, Manalapas almost ready for the run-up again. We have 27 Rudolph and Sanford 6 back. Good boot again. This one's going to be in the end zone, and he'll not take this one out. They'll bring it up to the 20-yard line. All right.
8 or 9 yards back into the end zone. What a foot.
All right, let's look at the Hoosiers on defense. From left to right, Panak, Hammerstein, Troy Drake. He's a good one. He's one of the starters back from last year. And Nathan Davis. The linebackers. Bill Mallory said this might be his best all-round linebacking crew, Joe Huff, Wilmot, Terrell, and Thurman.
I'll tell you, they're very impressive, very strong and quick.
Smedley, Mucci, Warnicki, and Brown. Lance, a part-time starter last year, so 2.5 starters back on the defense for the Hoosiers, and we're set to go from the 20-yard line. Hoosiers leading 7-0, just under 13 minutes remaining. First quarter, live from Commonwealth Stadium. Williams again gets a nice little jag out to the 25, the 26-yard line. And Trevor Wilmot, 96 on the stop. Trevor, 6'2", 220, a senior from Evanston, Illinois, the number two tackler on this team. Wilmot has one sack so far this year and three tackles for loss. We're in a second down and three situation. Second and three, ball's on the 27-yard line. 12.5 minutes remaining, first quarter, and IU with that 7-0 lead as Kentucky comes out in the I formation. Leon Smith has checked in, number 13 for Kentucky. That is EY. And the hand is to Williams again. Fires to right side, and he has nothing.
Indiana doing a great job against the run early on, and it's great to see that defense stepping up.
Right at the bottom of that pile, big number 66, Troy Drake, 95, Canuck. Look at it on slow-mo here. Nothing extraordinary about that play, just a breakdown and blocking from that right side of the Kentucky line.
Don, I like the 4-3 defense that they're running now. When I played, we were in a 52, which was a read defense. This 4-3 is an attack defense, and you must go out and attack the linemen, and they're showing that today, and that's why they're stopping.
You want to sit back on that when you go out and get them. Third down, 4 yards to go. This is a situation IU would like to have them in, a passing situation on the 26. Long count by O'Farrell, and he will throw. Intends to Rudolph, overthrows him. They're covering Lance Brown. Now, this is what we talked about before the game, too, guys. Kentucky is just going to have to show Indiana that it can throw the football, and so far it hasn't. There's Rudolph over there, 27, and Nichols again has to be thinking, I wonder if they'll do this again. He's about in the same spot, right back there at the 11, 12-yard line, and deep is Eddie Beatty at about the 35 for IU. Nichols gets it off this time, a nice spiral. Eddie chases it down at the 35. 40. And the 42, possibly the 43-yard line. 7-0 IU. We're back in a minute. 13, Leon Smith.
Punt cover 39 yards.
What a start.
Nice job.
I tell you, they score here, it's gonna make it get ugly.
Yep.
I think.
Joe's look at Joe here. Joe's put me in, coach.
Okay, 10 seconds, here we go. Bill Curry on the sidelines, back to the live action. You see the time remaining first quarter. Smith gets it again this time. He really hustles for the yardage he got. I thought he was going to be stopped at the line of scrimmage.
And he almost lost the pigskin there. Joe, we were talking about IU. They've had five turnovers and five fumbles and lost four of them so far this year.
Alex needs, he is young, but he needs to learn to hold on to that football.
But what kind of talent is this kid? He's amazing.
He is, I put him in a combination of both Anthony Thompson and Von Dunbar. He has great work ethic, but he's also quick like Von Dunbar.
Last week against Miami of Ohio, 33 tries, 191 yards. He's averaging 172. Guess who has the football on the slant to the far side to the 40 and the 39-yard line before he's brought down on the far side by Eric Wright. Wright is a small man for a linebacker at 5'8", 202 pounds, just a sophomore from football-rich Massillon, Ohio. Nice cut to the outside there by Smith. Made his own way. The missed tackle, and he made him miss on that one. And finally run down by Wright. So, go ahead, guys.
Well, you got to be good if you're leading the Big Ten in rushing. He's sixth in the nation.
That's all right, amazing. Four carries for Smith, 40 yards. First down, 10 from the 39, 10-17 remaining first quarter. Pacey made the good call. Center made the good call on that one, too. Jay Sive, number 52, said he's offside. I'll snap it and take the 5-yard lines. Let's see if we're right.
I'll go with that. I'll second that notion. Lots of movement there.
There was a nice count there by Pacey, and the call is offside. Kentucky, good. So it'll be a first and five now from... right on the 34-yard line. All right, take a peek at the officials right here now, and we have a split crew, the referee Tommy Quinn, the umpire Brian Ballet, the linesman Mike Spanier, the line judge Dick Honig, side, field, and back judge Freund, Colburn, and...
On the defense. 5 yards.
And thank you for the call, and Sieberman. All right, 10 minutes, 9 seconds remaining. This is just first quarter here, folks. We got off with a bang if you joined us late. Hoosiers blocked a punt from Kentucky. Two plays are in the end zone. 7-0, first and 5 from the 34 for IU. Smith.
Wow.
Big hole, 20, 19, 18-yard line. He is going untouched. Johnson finally picked him off at the 18. We'll set it for you at the 17-yard line.
They're dominating line of scrimmage right here. Look at the holes.
As I mentioned, the 4-3 defense is an attack defense. And Kentucky right now is not attacking the line of scrimmage, and that's why these holes are developing.
All right, take a look at a different angle here. This is a really nice look at it here. Oh, good block right there. Was that Lee, 37?
Great cutback.
And a nice cutback. You're right. He read that perfectly. And the IU... boys in the red zone once again.
First from the 17. Smith tries the right side this time. Reads his block well. Takes the chop inside. And he gets a pretty decent block there on the outside by Clay Williams, number 78. There is a flag on the play, and here's the official call. Hold, Indiana. So we'll bring it back. A momentary diversion, we hope. 9 minutes, 27 seconds remaining first quarter. It would have been second and 6 from that spot right there. No question what Kentucky's going to do.
Andrew Green caught with his hand in the cookie jar there.
Holding on the offense.
Down the way I analyze it, the lineman hold every play. Speaking from a former linebacker.
Yes. That's almost the way it is, though, isn't it, Joe? I mean, if you look at Bill Curry right there, it's just whether you get caught or not.
That's true. So true.
Joe, how you feeling being up in the booth? I know you kept talking about how you'd like to take the headset off and go down there and play a little linebacker.
Well, his headset feels like a helmet. Feels like I'm ready to go. I think I'd only last a few plays, though.
There are Pacey's numbers, 16 for 24. Stoner in the ball game. Glover in the ball game. Glover back there with Smith. That is he with the ball. Going to the far side. Gets a little running room. Nice run on his part. Sean Glover was the starting fullback last year. Now he's switching time with Lee. You get a just a little bit different look when Glover in the ball game because he's going to carry from time to time and he'll catch it from time to time. Lee has not touched the ball yet this year.
He has not touched the ball, and McKinnon has not caught a pass. So it's going to be interesting to see which one either catches the ball or runs the ball first.
What's the wager? Who do you think?
I'm going to go with Lee,
all right,
the big guy.
All right, we'll have to take McKinnon then. Well, I think we're going to lose. But
that's right.
Second and 14 for the Hoosiers from the 21, already leading 7-0, 8.5 minutes remaining first half. Look at Kentucky sneak up on the option. Pacey keeps down across the 15 to the 14, possibly the 13-yard line before he's tripped up there. Take out a peek from the low angle here and check out Pacey on this play. Oh, a nice shot on this one. Pacey to the far side with a little option play. John likes this, doesn't he? He likes to run.
I like to see the option. Kentucky's a traditional option team. It's nice to see that we're coming right back with him with the option.
Well, the Kentucky players trying to get the fans involved here. They have the majority of the crowd. We see about 500 to 1,000 Reds in the corner. Third and 7 from the 14. And the gun. Pacey has his man. It's Bruner at about the 3-4 yard line. Bruner makes the stop. Bruner at 6'3", 200, the sophomore from Ben Davis High School, a little alma mater there, huh?
He had quite a career, Ben Davis. Nice to see the pattern that he's running here, and he's been dependable for the Hoosiers so far.
Now Pacey had all day to throw it, too.
You know, we talked about Alex rankings in the Big Ten. John is leading the Big Ten in his passing efficiency.
So it's a first down and goal from the 4-yard line for IU. Again, leading 7-0 with 7 minutes and 44 seconds remaining in the first quarter. Pacey changing the play at the line of scrimmage. He has the option to do that. George Ballou, the offensive coordinator, told me anytime. Smith's run, maybe a yard, maybe two to the far side.
Don, you had a chance to go down and talk with most of the coaches on Thursday. They must have been real informative. And the emotions of this game, I mean, these guys are juiced, aren't they?
Oh, they really are. What a help to talk to both George Ballou, the offensive coordinator, and Joe Novak, the defensive coordinator, give you real insight to the ball game, what they're going to try to do, what Kentucky's going to try to do to them.
Very respectful coaching staff. Everybody in the whole country looks up to Bill Mallory.
Second, third down, second and goal from the 3. IU leading already 7-0. Smith, right half. And did he make it?
Boy, how did he get in there?
Well, the players say yes. The officials say about 2 inches short. How can they see that? How can they see that? It looked like he was in. I'd like to see a goal line angle on that one.
I'm gonna mark it there.
Take a peek from in tight.
Well, he had a nice second effort there.
Coming right at you. Right at you. Hang on to the ball, Alec.
Oh, boy, almost lost it again there, Joe.
They were right. All right, third and goal. Let's look for a QB sneak here. And we called that
John
one.
Called it.
John Pacey brings it into the end zone, and we have a touchdown IU. Kentucky thought there was a fumble, but he had crossed the line. And IU leads 13-0, and there's John Pacey. What a guy he is. I really enjoyed him last week, too. Very intelligent guy, very hardworking, looks at a lot of film. He's always ready to play in the ballgame.
There he is punching it across, and I'll tell you what, Commonwealth Stadium is in shock right now. 58,000 on hand, about maybe 500 to 1,000 IU fans, and they're up having a good old time.
From the Craig Goody hold, Bill Manilopoulos has his second point after he missed his first in 35 attempts last week. 14-0 IU. We're back in a minute. Now your drive, 10 plays, 57 yards. It took him 5 minutes and 8 seconds, so they get the quick touchdown. There's George Ballou right there with Pacey. And we were just talking about third down efficiency a second ago. IU now for the year, 80%.
That's unbelievable.
Unbelievable.
Coming into the game, they were 75% from the red zone. Quick stats on Alex Smith, 9 carries, 66 yards, and 1 TD. Of course, he already has 2 100-yard games and on his way to making it 3 here.
Deep again for Kentucky as you look there at Bill Manilopoulos and the penalty off the extra point. They'll kick off from the 50-yard line. Let's see if he pooches it to get it in play or kicks it out of the end zone. I would like him to kick it out of the end zone.
He could make a field goal here, Don.
Yeah, he could. There are a couple of quickies. Al, he got it into play. Yeah. And Wyatt downs it in the end zone. So Randy Wyatt, number 3 from Paducah, 5'10", 175, and a senior. You know what amazed me, guys, while we're talking about Wyatt here? This guy is their long snapper at 175 pounds. Can you believe that? Wouldn't you like to line up nose-to-nose on him on an extra one?
Well, they might try to flatten him. When you're a little kid, you put your hand on the ball and say, DC on hiker, no smash in the center. I don't think that you can do that in this game.
He'd be meat, wouldn't he?
The numbers on Antonio O'Farrell. Zip from the passing department. Zip in the running department as they come out in the gun to start it from the 20-yard line, trailing 14-0, 6:22 left, first quarter, IU. O'Farrell says, let's put this thing up in the air. Gets a wobbler out on the far sideline. Had his man out at the 40-yard line. Complete to Leon Smith. Leon at 5'10", 176, a junior from Louisville Trinity High School. And Eric Smedley picks up the tackle. Smedley at 5'11", 193, a junior from Chesterton, West Virginia.
Joe, this is a pretty ugly pass, wouldn't you say?
Yeah, but the receiver was wide open. I think when you look at what happened at Kentucky, Kentucky's traditionally a running team out of the eye. As you can see, they got down here and they're coming out in their shotgun. That's not their game.
And O'Farrell took a hit.
The hit on the QB afterwards. He's going to have to think, well, I guess we can see the trend in the game very quickly right here. They dumped the run, which is their strong point, and O'Farrell's going to put it up in the air. The first two plays, and a dying quail again. He has Wyatt this time for another first down as he crosses the 50 down to the 47-yard line. Randy Wyatt. He's their top receiver. Coming into this ball game, he had 13 balls for 64 yards. And obviously their top catcher on the year. We haven't seen anything at all yet of their top man in the previous game against Florida, Isaac Curtis, who caught five balls. Well, you're going to hear that a couple of times tonight here. First down, Kentucky. All right, O'Farrell keeps him in the gun and has Williams to his near side. A first from the 47, 5:44 remaining. First quarter, 14-0 IU, and the hand to Williams. The draw, good yardage, enough for a first down again, down to the IU 35-yard line. Chris Mucci, 39, makes the stop for IU. Mucci, a walk-on from Hendersonville, North Carolina at 5'11", 185, and a junior. How often does that happen, Joseph, as you look at the replay again here on the draw, that you get a walk-on playing big-time football?
Well, Don, I was Coach Mallory's first walk-on in scholarship, and Coach really likes the work ethic by a walk-on. That's his kind of mentality, his attitude. It's just a shame that the NCAA is going to take the scholarships from 100 down to an 85. It's going to hurt the walk-ons.
Numbers on Mo Williams, 5 for 21, a first from the 36-yard line, 5:15 remaining, first quarter. High snap, O'Farrell handles it, gets it away. Mucci almost had that one. I think he was a little bit surprised, too, that it was right in his arm. So it'll be a second down and 10. This is what you'd like to do to a ball club like Kentucky, a running team passing the football. You'd like them to be in this situation. O'Farrell getting plenty of time to throw it. This one has a little bit better spiral, only he doesn't find his man. And Mucci knocks it away. So the second and 10 from the 36. 14-0 IU. There's a look at Chris. And we go to the I formation. The up man is Hood, the fullback. And the keeper by O'Farrell. Gets to the 35-yard line. May have gotten just a couple on the play. Lewis Pinnock making the stop. Big guy, his first letter. At fullback for IU. He's a two-year letterman.
Delivered a nice hit there.
Well, he's a strong, quick player.
What's it been like on campus this week, Joe? The guys getting ready for this game. I bet it's been a lot of fun.
Oh, it's a rival game, so they're always pumped up. I think Coach prepared them in the right fashion. A lot of them came in and watched film in there bright and early on Monday morning.
Third and 8 from the 34 for Kentucky, and O'Farrell changes the play. And the draw again, right up the gut to Williams. He's not going to get anything close to the first down. And the question is, are they in field goal territory?
Their field goal kicker has not attempted a field goal yet this year.
Ryan Savinsky, as a matter of fact, he started at IU as a wrestler and came over here to Kentucky. Now that is he in the ball game, number 41, as you look at Bill Curry, who's been in coaching 15 years, five of those here at Kentucky. So from the 37-yard line, a 47-yard attempt on fourth and 5. Did he get it? Looks good.
Yep.
Is good. There's his first touchdown field goal as a collegian. And the first score of the night, 14-3 IU. We're back in a minute.
I thought you were sending me. I'm going.
So Brian Savinsky breaks the ice for Kentucky, 14-3 in favor of the Hoosiers. We still have 3 minutes and 37 seconds remaining in the first quarter. Seven plays, 49 yards. Took him 3 minutes and 15 seconds to do it. Officially, that's a 48-yard field goal by Savinsky. Matthews, 3. Jermaine Cheney, 2. Deep for IU. And there will be a run back on this one. Matthews at the 7. The 20 and the 24, and he's literally upended. At time, James Tucker, 32, makes the stop for Kentucky.
Don, we were talking during the break here, and Joe Huff made a good point. He says he doesn't think, you don't think that Kentucky can stop the run. I think it'll be a lot like the Miami game last week. Just keep handing off.
Right, I think we're going to see Indiana come out and still try, or keep the running game going.
Just keep pounding.
We may not see DiGiulio tonight, huh?
That'd be nice.
That'd be
real good. All right, for the Hoosiers, first and 10 from the 24, leading 14-3. And Law is in the game for the first time. Brett Law gets his first carry. You have to look a couple of times, 23 and 22.
Brett Law celebrating his 23rd birthday tonight. I had a chance to talk with him last week, Don, and he said he wants nothing more than a big one at UK.
Happy birthday, Brett.
Hey, is that a breathtaking shot or not from Chopper 13? Beauteous. And there's a look at Brett Law from Sheridan, Indiana. The two players on the same team who hold all the records for rushing in Indiana high school football.
Unbelievable.
Pacey swings. Glover across the 25 to the 27-yard line. Sean Glover, his first reception of the night. Glover last year was very dependable. 27 catches for 186 yards. He has a couple this year. That's his third on the little swinger. Pacey looks him off and gets it out there. And a nice play there, too, by Stoner, not wanting to take the back block. He just kind of let him go. He said, I'd rather have that much of a game on third and 6 from the 28. Well, the fans getting into it. Pacey pulls it down, has the first, and plenty more up to the 45-yard line. John Pacey.
Beautiful, beautiful scramble.
Now, John likes to do this, obviously. Pull it down. He likes the option offense. He likes to run the football. Looks at all his options and said, let me take it down.
Joe's a linebacker. What are you thinking right here, huh?
Well, I'm looking at Pacey. He's really, really quick. I mean, you got to keep your eye on him. You know, it's interesting. O'Farrell and Pacey are both from New York and played each other in high school. O'Farrell had the advantage 2-1 over. You know, John's going to try to get back on him tonight.
The big one, yeah.
That's a first for IU at the 45, obviously. Out here to the near side is Stoner, who made that good non-block on the last play across the 50, down to the 45. That is enough for another first down for IU. And they're going to mark it at the 44 of Kentucky. Welcome if you've just joined us as you look there at Stoner, 16, 14, 3 IU, a minute 37 remaining in the first quarter as Pacey rips it to the near sidelines, and Stoner is there to grab it for the Hoosiers.
Boy, it's gone just like the Hoosiers won it so far.
Ajamu Stoner from Louisville, Kentucky, 6'1", 180, just a sophomore. First from the 44 of Kentucky. Lee pulls to the far side. Law makes his own way. Good fake. Out to the near side, and it is Klusmeyer on the grab from Anderson, the young man who did such a nice job in football, basketball, and track for the Indians last year. Beautiful faking in the backfield by Pacey. I like that.
Excellent fake. Faked it and rolled out and had plenty of time to set it up and let the play develop. This is what I noticed about him last week, Joe. He has a lot of patience back there to let it develop.
He's a talented athlete.
I was talking to Pacey about this on Thursday. This is what they call a naked play. Just say it's a regular play and they just call it naked. That means he'll come out to the near side or the far side all by himself. It's always interesting to see what you get. That's Law right up over the gut. Did he fumble it? And I see a flag on the play too. So we'll wait for both of those. No indication yet from the official that there was a fumble. The clock is rolling. No fumble at all. IU football down at the 17-yard line.
Coach Mallory was, excuse me, Don, was concerned after the Miami game, Joe, talking about the fact that they need to protect the ball more. He said, you know, in the red zone especially.
That's been a problem. The red zone, as you indicated, is 20 yards in. Indiana wants to score every time they're in that 20-yard line.
First and five from the 17. This time Bruner is out to the near side. And Matthews to the far. Lee the up man. And Cheney right up the gut makes his own way across the 10 down to about the 8-yard line. Wow, there, IU has so many good tailbacks.
Another fresh pair of legs in there.
Yeah, everybody's getting in the mix early on. That's good to see.
Well, a good indication, I think, of how good Smith is Cheney was a starter last year and had a great year. Jermaine probably the fastest guy on the team, huh, Joe?
Oh, he is quick. He ran track last year for Indiana.
All right, here we go. First and goal from the 8-yard line. 12 seconds left in the quarter. Jermaine up the middle again, across the 5, down to the 4. And that'll be the last play of the first quarter. And IU leads Kentucky at the end of one period, 14-3. The Hoosiers in position to put another 6 points on the board. We'll call it the 4-yard line as you look at John Pacey coming out of the huddle. Second and goal from the 4. There's another naked play.
Wide open.
Klusmeier. Touchdown IU.
Great ball fake.
Well, that's one of those plays where the quarterback just has to feel it again. He thinks that they're over pursuing, and that's the kind of play he likes. Pacey with a great fake.
Kind of looks like Kentucky's constricting on the run right there, and they're not covering the people out of the back in the pass. That's what happened.
And look at McKinnon, how happy he is. Big number 86 didn't get a hold of the ball, but he's also happy for Klusmeier, too.
They have taken Kentucky totally out of this game.
And given IU a penalty for celebration, too, which will be marched off, I'm assuming, on the kickoff.
Exactly.
Let's go ahead quickly here with the first half stats. No surprises, fellas. Yards rushing, the Hoosiers 104 yards.
Unnecessary celebration.
There we get the call. Kentucky with only 23 yards rushing. Don?
23 yards rushing.
23.
Well, they're really trying to stomp down on the unnecessary celebrations this year. And we were just talking before the game about what happened to Cincinnati in the first game. It was just a little bit of a celebration, not extraordinary at all, and that hurt him. That really changed the picture of the ball game. 20-3
call.
IU. Yeah. And Manilopoulos right down the pipe. And IU leads 21-3 with 14 minutes and 54 seconds remaining in the first half. Take this break, and we'll be right back here at Commonwealth Stadium in Lexington.
A lot of stadiums or teams out there that are hurting for fans, and I kind of like that spirit right there.
Well, especially when you're up 21-3. Yeah. The Hoosiers are dominating.
The Hoosiers, they
want to
see
right
their
now.
Players out there.
Indiana fans ought to be fired up on a Saturday night right now. My.
And Klusmeier, if I'm not mistaken, that's his first collegiate touchdown. 21-3 IU, and there will be a run back by Rudolph from the 22. Nice little move there. He is also a track man up over the 45 to about the 49-yard line.
Rich Kearney in there making a tackle, the wide receiver.
Boy, he's a tough one. He's 5'9", 160 pounds.
Gets the stop for IU.
Yeah.
Yeah, this guy is a world-class sprinter. He is an All-American 5 times in the 200-meter dash. He's the SEC champion in that event, and he moves nice.
Here it is for the record, your first quarter stats. Look at the big difference there in rushing, 104-23. And first downs, Indiana with 10, Kentucky with 3. 151 yards to 55.
From the 49. O'Farrell, little reverse to Rudolph. Got some room, 50, 45, 40-yard line. And making the stop was Mucci on the far side. Chris Mucci reached out and literally tripped up Rudolph. And he fell forward to about the 41-yard line.
He may have had more running room on this reverse here if Mucci wouldn't have tripped him up.
A great misdirection play. They had everything going to the right and came back to the left.
He gets the corner right there. There's nobody waiting for him.
Good thing he spun around in there. He would have been gone.
from the 40-yard line. First down, 10 yards to go for Kentucky's Wildcats, trailing 21-3, 14:36 remaining in the half. That's Hood, the fullback, over the right guard. Maybe a yard, two at the most. We'll call it a yard and a half. And the center of that IU defensive line, Pinnock 95, Hammerstein 63, Troy Drake 66, Nathan Davis 98, and the linebackers, Wilmot 96, Terrell 41, Thurman 48, the backfield of Smedley, Warnicki, Brown, and Mucci. Second and 8 from the 38 for Kentucky. Farrell swings it out here. That was very nearly a lateral. Very, very close to a lateral. And I think many times the coach says, you know, be careful of that. If it's very close at all, just cover the thing so we don't take any chances, because that was right on the line.
Eric Smedley was waiting for him. He said, go ahead and catch it. I'm ready for you.
You know, Don, you were talking about Indiana's defense. Last year they were 10th in the nation. A lot of questions about this year's team coming in with the defensive backs and the front line. And four guys off of the defense last year went to the professional in the NFL. I think it's a great defense. They're just as good as last year.
Well, it was the 10th in the nation last year. O'Farrell, 2 of 6 on the night for 32 yards. Staring him a 3rd and 8. Sampled across the 35 down to the 33-yard line. He'll be about 3 yards short of the first.
On the stop is number 63, John Hammerstein.
Hammerstein makes the stop for IU. Big John.
The Sanford.
Yeah, look at him. He just, it's almost a pick play over there, isn't it, Joe? I mean, his guy comes in front of him.
Well, I'll tell you what, that's a tough place for a receiver coming over the middle like that. If there's a linebacker sitting there, he might clean your clock.
Now Kentucky's going to go for it here on 4th and 4 from the 34. They bring Smith to the far side along with Wyatt. They have Curtis and Rudolph on the near side. 4 wideouts. Williams with O'Farrell in the backfield. That is Williams. First down. And then some.
O'Farrell is complete to Mo Williams. Running out by number 97, Eli Rashid.
Mo Williams. They try to get it in his hands as much as possible for obvious reasons. Just a little swing pass to the near side.
It's a gain of about 10 yards.
Mucci comes up and contests, and Williams won that battle. There's a look at Mo. One of the blue chippers in the nation. A lot of people tried to get Mo Williams. All right, a first from the 24 for the Wildcats. Just under 13 minutes remaining in the first half. 21-3 IU. O'Farrell swings it to the far side to Williams, and ooh, he got knocked by Smedley right when he got the ball.
Read that one nicely.
Oh, that one. For Williams, incomplete, broken up by Eric Smedley.
Got a big hit replay coming up for you here.
Smedley's developed into a great football player. Last year, he was a special team favorite. If you remember the punts when we get him down to about the 5-yard line, he was the man running down there and keeping him from going into the end zone.
Ooh.
Well, that's a classic tackle, isn't it?
How you doing tonight?
Yeah. Nice job, Eric.
Boy, that feels good when you do that.
5'11", 193, a junior from Chesterton, West Virginia. Ellums and Goody back now, 21-31. Ellums from Concordia, Fort Wayne, set all the records there as a tailback and a wideout. Oh, Wilmot also got him in the backfield, but it was gotten off quickly, and Smith gets it down to about the 12-yard line. Alfonso Thuman knocks him out of bounds right there.
Alfonso Thurman.
12 minutes and 44 seconds remaining in the first half. 21-3 IU. That is the first down at the 12. And O'Farrell had to take it in the chops to get that one off. Well, Kentucky spreads them out again with the 4 wideouts. You remember what they did last time, just swung it out here to the near side to Williams. Let's see what they do this time.
First real test for the Hoosier D.
Who intended for Curtis, and he was whacked on the goal line. Isaac Curtis right at the goal line by Lance Brown puts the hit on him.
The senior 203-6-1. That was a beautiful hit.
Lance started 6 games last year, but he hurt an ankle and lost his starting job. Watched the knock right there. Mm. Oh, Isaac's going to remember that one. You remember his father when he played all those great seasons for the Cincinnati Bengals.
Wearing that number.
Same number. 21-3 IU, 12 minutes, 38 seconds remaining first half. Second and 10 for Kentucky from the 12. Farrell gives it to Hood up the middle, and he fooled exactly no one. Lewis Pinnock was there for the stop. So it'll be third and 10 for Kentucky. We're still at the 12-yard line. Clock is running. We have 12 minutes and 19 seconds remaining. Be sure to check us out at halftime here. We'll update you on all the news you need to know from News Channel 13.
And also Coach Bill Mallory will join us. He said he'd stop and talk to us.
Oh, great.
On the way in.
Tenth play of the drive here, David and Joe. And we stay in the gun. Third and 10 from the 12. Into the end zone. Curtis. Touchdown. Isaac Curtis comes right back from that big hit from Lance Brown. And there's a little courage from the young man.
Let's watch it on the replay here.
Cincinnati. Good pass, too. That was right there.
Beautifully thrown ball. You can't do much against that, can you?
I know Doug Mallory's probably a little worried right now with his defensive back. It's his first year coaching. We lost Bob Morris to Purdue, went over there as their defensive quarter, or as their coordinator, and I think Doug right now is probably a little concerned.
Smedley covering on that play, and Savinsky gets the extra point, and it's a 21-10 ball game. IU leading, 11:48 left, first half, and we're back in a minute. And the kickoff by Savinsky. We'll have the scoring drive for you here in just a second. Cheney at the five. Cheney up to the 25, to the 27. He needed one more block.
Don, the Wildcats scoring drive. 10 plays, 51 yards. They took 3 minutes and 6 seconds off the clock. 12-yard pass from O'Farrell to Isaac Curtis III. 21-10. The Indiana Hoosiers on top with 11:44 left in the first half.
Well, Joe Huff, with that scoring drive, that had to give Kentucky a little more confidence in its offense.
Right. I think if they wouldn't have driven the ball down there, they could have fallen down or just went flat. But it's important now that Indiana still establishes a running game right now and keep the control of the ball.
Matthews far side, Beatty near side, I formation, lead the up man, and Alex Smith gets the call near side, has some room, 30, 35, 40, 41 yard line, hangs on to the ball, and he's finally brought down by Johnson. Melvin Johnson, definitely the top tackler on this ball club, and he's also their biggest hitter.
Alex Smith, let's watch the replay right here, averaging 170 plus yards a game. And there he is doing his magic.
Put on the afterburner to get rid of one tackle, but Johnson met him nicely, and Alex hung on. First and 10 from the 43-yard line of IU. Leading 21-10, Beatty in motion to the far side. Smith right up the gut. Across the quarter to the 49-yard line.
Joe, they seem to be doing a lot of arm tackling.
I'll tell you, Alex is quick. The more I watch him, the more impressed I am. He's just quick as a cat. Watch his cutbacks.
Look at the blocking on the right side there.
And when he cuts, he doesn't lose speed. That's right. Very important.
Straight ahead.
All right, a second and four from the 49 for the Hoosiers. Boy, just a magnificent night here. Beautiful weather. Rained a little bit during the day. They had the field covered, so the turf is superior. Alex again crossed the 50 down to the 45, possibly the 44 yard line. No, they're going to mark it right on the 45. So that'll be another first down for the Hoosiers. They've been racking them up tonight.
Indiana going right back to the running game.
Joe, how is Alex Smith received among his teammates?
Everybody, you know, his work ethic. You can't you know, argue with anybody that works hard and respect. They respect him for his work ethic.
Pacey making the call at the line of scrimmage. First down from the 45 of Kentucky. The pass has his man. We'll wait just for a second. I think it was Klusmeyer. We'll see. Across the 40, it was. Klusmeyer across the 40, down to about the 37-yard line, where it'll be just short of a first down. Hoosmeyer went down right with the ball, and Pacey put it where only Ben could grab it.
They're using the tight end a lot tonight.
They are, isn't that? That's unusual. IU usually doesn't throw to its tight end.
Big Ben getting a lot of work in tonight.
They're usually the dump-off guys. There's the inside handle to Glover, and nobody fooled on that one. That's News making the stop, and finally Glover falls down. And a gain of zero on that play, a possible loss of one.
Great read by Matt News, 56, the linebacker, 223-6-2.
And he's also a New York kid. He's that kind of that New York combo that we were talking about there with O'Farrell.
Exactly. He played on O'Farrell's high school team also, so he's had some experience going against Pacey.
All right. IU successful on 80% of its third down tries this season. This is a third and three from the 38. The option, John, very close. Did they put his knee down? They have it right on the yard line, and if that's it, that should be enough for the first.
See if they're going to mark his knee there, the way he fell forward here.
Now this official, the linesman on the near side, had him right on the yard line, and that's where they placed the ball. And they're going to measure it, but it appears as if that IU has enough for the first down with the nose just across the 35-yard line. 21-10 in favor of IU. Well, it started off as a route here, folks. It is a first down with the... really about the fifth play of the game. IU sneaking into the end zone from 9 yards out. Alex Smith on a blocked punt by Goody.
Two plays later, Alex was in the end zone, wasn't he?
Yeah. John's down there fired up. He's got that first down.
I think this is an important drive for him, isn't it,
yeah,
Joe?
He's
answer back here.
First from the 35. Smith.
He's gone.
Smith! At the 10-5, and he's going to be out at about the 1 yard line. Keo Wilson caught up with him at the one. Great change of direction. And an excellent block by Eric Matthews and Eddie Beatty, the wideouts, holding their ground. And a great low angle look here at Alex Smith.
You know, this kid has had so much success, Joe. I heard a lot of people saying, yeah, that was against UC in Miami, though.
Well, I'll tell
look
you what
he's doing tonight.
Nice run. All right, we have a timeout on the field. There are his numbers, 13 for 127, averaging just short of 10 on the night. Now, we told you before the game, he's averaging 172, got 191 last week, 152 against Cincinnati. 8 minutes and 36 seconds remaining first half. IU leading 21-10. First and goal from the one for the Hoosiers. And you've got your same lineup with Lee, the up man from Lawrence North. And Smith from Franklin County, the tailback. It looks like a touchdown. He hung on. It is, says IU. The officials say not quite. Not quite. Yeah, take a peek here at the leap. Well, they gained a half yard, huh, guys?
Here's the leap. Looked like he had the momentum.
Well, a good stop in there, too, by Johnson. He's been all over the place tonight, hasn't he? He is a player. Melvin Johnson. Second and goal from the half yard line. Sneak Pacey.
I think we got it that time.
Yeah, we'll have to wait till they unpile on this one. IU likes it again. The officials like it this time. And the Hoosiers are in the end zone with their third effort of the night, 27, fourth effort of the night, 27-10.
There's the surge by the line. They've been dominating all night long, especially with the run, Joe.
Big night for Pacey right now. I know he's probably looking over there at O'Farrell going, that's two touchdowns I got. Wanting a couple more.
And the extra point from Manilopoulos has a knuckler. And it was tipped and goes in. 28-10 IU, 7:48 left from Chopper 13. We're back in a minute. We'll be right back.
guy. Hey, you met you.
All right. The drives, okay. Every one has been a touchdown.
Okay. I hit the replays harder. Okay. Okay.
All right.
Okay.
Welcome back. Yes, sir. Welcome back to Commonwealth Stadium. And look at this. Is this what a coach likes to see? Four drives, four touchdowns for IU. 28-10 with 7:48 left in the half.
The last one, the classic. Nine plays, 72 yards. 1 yard run by John Pacey, his second of the night.
Rudolph on the run back. 15, 20, 25-yard line. And he stopped right there at the 26 by the Hoosiers. Good coverage so far on not only the punts, but the kickoffs. And the Hoosiers have had plenty of those to look at tonight.
That was a big concern going into this week, the coverage, both on the punt and the kickoff. And I know Coach worked on it a lot this week. And as you said, Don, they're doing an excellent job tonight.
Now we're about to see number 14 come in the ball game. I met Ditto's parents right before the game.
Well, he's a great kid. He understands. He's got the talent. It's just Pacey's year this year.
All right. 28-10 IU, 7:40 left. First half, first down for Kentucky from the 27. In motion, Wyatt to the near side. Fake by O'Farrell. For Wyatt at the 30, drops it. Coverage, coaching. Mucci has had a lot of work here tonight. And Kentucky trying to give Indiana a few more different looks with people in motion. Tried about everything, haven't
they? They're trying anything right now. You're right.
Well, I like to see those walk-ons doing well. He's doing a heck of a job.
We led you into that one, big fella. Coming to the near side, Curtis 85. And Wyatt 3. And Smith to the far side in the slot. Well, has some time here and has Smith on the far side. Has about 3 yards in the play. Nice coverage by Indiana.
Indiana's kind of sitting back right now. Need to get a pass rush. The defensive line needs to get in there on the quarterback.
Now we're going to watch the receivers here. We watch the replay. Look at the time he's getting here, Joe.
Yeah, like as I mentioned, the defensive up front has to get in there. Put some pressure on him.
He hangs right in the pocket. He's obviously not a classic pocket passer, but he hangs right in there. And Smith with the reception. We have a third, 3 from the 34. 6 minutes and 54 seconds left in the half. IU 28-10. O'Farrell, Curtis, first down. That's it. He actually went back and Mucci made the stop.
Nice cutback.
Again, Don, to bring that receiver over the middle. One of these linebackers is going to pop one of them there in a minute.
It takes a little courage, too, huh? Yeah. You were talking about just kind of sitting back there in that zone, and you can see it on that play right there. And he just kind of got in the crease of that zone, Curtis did, and Mucci waited for him on the far side. That's a first on the 40. 6.5 left in the first half. 28-10 IU. Four times touching the ball, four touchdowns for the Hoosiers.
Kentucky's back in their eye back again.
There's that triple option. O'Farrell pitching out to Williams. It's covered nicely. Williams might be 2 yards. Talk me through this one as Troy Drake gets the tackle. Talk me about responsibilities from the defensive people on the triple option, Joe.
Troy's main objective, he doesn't have to read the quarterback as much unless he's on a slant. It's the outside people that have the main responsibility. You got to know who's taking the dive man, who's taking the quarterback, or who's taking the tailback. If you lose your responsibility in the option, it can hurt you tremendously.
Second and 8 from the 42. Second and 8 for Kentucky. And the Hoosiers with a 5-man front. The pitch to Williams. Williams gets a couple.
Kentucky the last 2 times trying to get outside the IU's 4-3 defense.
Craig Goody seeing a lot of action tonight. Well, I'm just going to get to play a lot, too. He's
Another walk-on.
The true freshman, yeah. Is that right?
No, he's the freshman, his brother.
This is Coach Bill Mallory. I'll be heading down to the sidelines here, and hopefully we'll get the chance to talk to him momentarily, guys, before halftime,
all
right?
Go get him.
Okay.
All right. Dave Calabro down to the sidelines for halftime. Third and 5, Kentucky on the 45-yard line. A flag on the play. O'Farrell gets it off. Incomplete. Intended for the tight end, Chris Davis. Davis, the biggest guy out on the field for them at 6'7", 273, just a sophomore from Roanoke, Alabama. Was a defensive end, and you can see right there why he was a defensive end.
Well, he's a big one. He looks like a basketball player out there.
He does. And doesn't have a lot of good hands. That was right in his mitts as you look at Thurman. He's a heck of a player, isn't he?
Oh, great individual.
Illegal procedure on the offense. Only 6 men on the line of scrimmage. Penalties
illegal procedure against Kentucky. Only 6 men on the line of scrimmage. And it's declined by Indiana. That brings up a fourth down. And Nicky Nichols comes into the ball game. The punter, he'll get it away from about the 30-yard line. And Eddie Beatty back at the 15 for IU, the lone safety.
That was a good stop for Indiana.
Especially after both of them had thrown it, you know, down each other's throat there in successive series.
Kentucky's looking a little down over there. They all got their heads down.
All right, let's take a break right here. 28-10 IU, 4:48 left, first half. Line here, actually the 11, 4:48 remaining the half, 28-10. The Hoosiers on top of Kentucky in this Bourbon Barrel rivalry. A handoff, Jermaine Chaney trying the right side, and he finds a lot of blue jerseys over there.
Well, they stuffed him up there. It came well with the blitz there. Kentucky's expecting Indiana to run the ball right now, Don. I think they're going to be blitzing into it.
I would think that IU would try to ram it right down their throat since they've scored every time they had the ball, and I would think they'd be idiotic unless they had to put it in the air here. Let's see if they can stop our best game.
Well, Ditto can drop back and throw the ball. Excellent thrower.
Well, we called it on the sidelines. He was ready to come in. Here's Chris, the big kid, classic drop back passer. Second down and 10 for the Hoosiers from the 11 at the 4-minute mark of the first half. Chaney again finds his way nicely across the 15, 20, 25, 30, 35-yard line. And Johnson knocks him out of bounds right there.
Chaney showed his speed on that play.
Now we were talking about the experience in track of Chaney, and he showed you a little bit right there. Ran at the NC2A Indoor Track and Field Championships in the 200 meters last winter. Makes a nice read there, didn't he, Joe, off the block.
And turns on the jets. There he goes. Excellent kid.
Big first down for IU across the 35-yard line. 3 minutes, 56 seconds left in the half. 28-10 IU. This time, Lee, the up man in the I formation. We're still with Chaney as the running back. That is he again across the near side. Finds a hole across the 45 to the 48-yard line. And Johnson is there to stop him again. He has the majority of the tackles for the Wildcats here tonight. He is an All-American candidate. Go ahead, Joseph.
IU's offensive line is dominating Kentucky's defense right now. Kentucky has got their heads down. It looks like they're waiting for halftime. They're going to have to pick it up here. Indiana's going to score again.
All right, mark it on the 48-yard line. IU's still plenty of time left here in the half to push another one in as you look at Chris Ditto up tight. The Deuce backfield. This time it's Brett Law with a good run across the 45 down to the 43-yard line. Brett Law from Sheridan, Indiana. And when one back gets tired, you bring in the next. Van Hiles on the stop. He was questionable for this game. He had a bad ankle, but obviously he's okay and is playing.
Gain of 9 on the play.
Well, that's scary for a defense when you look up there and you see 3 different running backs coming at you.
I would think so, too. Here we are tired, and they keep throwing guys at us, huh?
Chaney and Law and Smith. Oh.
Second and 1. Law has the first and plenty more down to the 35-yard line. Absolutely extraordinary when IU is stopped on any play on the ground. Stoner, Bruner checking in for IU. 7 and 16. And Beatty, 4. Lee coming out, 37. So we have almost a new unit in there now.
It's good to see Law running the ball this year. You know, in the spring, they had him at cornerback, Don. And he's been a running back his whole life, and it's good to see his final year he's going to be a running back.
All right, a first for IU from the 35. I bet that was kind of a downer for him, wasn't it, Joe, going to the defense?
Yeah, you always want to, you know, used to being a running back, and I think he feels more comfortable.
Cheney tried to juke his way for a couple of extra yards, and he did so across the 30 down to the 28-yard line. 2 minutes, 21 seconds remaining. Clock is running here in the first half. Take a peek at it here. Jermaine just didn't have that much room to run. Kind of bellied out to the near side, trying to get himself some running room. Got a block in there. There's the juke I was talking about. And he's picked up by two Kentucky tacklers. From the 27, a second and two.
A single back now.
Manolopoulos getting ready in case he's needed. He has not had to kick a field goal tonight. Just four extras. Long. 20, 15, down to the 13-yard line.
Boy, he took off out of that backfield quick, Don.
They said it was Cheney, but it was Law. And the nice blocks in there by Lukowski and Chris Smith. Take a peek right here. Yeah, Brett makes the good belly out.
Look at his eyes open there. Reading the field.
That's the difference between a good back and an average back, isn't it? That vision at the line
vision,
of scrimmage.
Exactly.
All right, it's a first from the 12-yard line. Just a minute and a half left in the first half. 28-10, IU. A good halftime show for you. Bring you up to date on the news from News Center 13. So hang in for that. We have Cheney this time. 10-5. He may score. He dropped the football. It's out of bounds, though. Luckily, it went out of bounds at the 4-yard line.
Got to hold on to that pigskin.
Jermaine Cheney had six, but coughed it up at the 4. Wow. Yeah, give him 8 on the play. Take a peek here at the blocking from Lee. Lee 37. Oh, 250 pounds of smash mouth right there. If the official would get out of the way, you could see Jermaine come your way. Here he is. And there goes the ball. Nice stop by Johnson.
Boy, Lee is a load. He's like a Mack truck coming through there.
Nice kid, too, from Lawrence North. Second and two from the 4. Can get a first down, not scoring. Trainee upended. Did he hold on? Yes. Did he make the first? We'll wait. Well, timeout, IU.
Heck of an effort.
Cheney just trying to get that first down. And Verdant, 93, makes the stop. Good hit right there. It looks like the Hoosiers are just short of first down, so we have a third and less than a yard from the 3. Third and less than a yard from the 3. Would you like a timeout here? All right, we'll leave you for a second and come right back. Welcome back to Commonwealth Stadium in Lexington, Kentucky. The Hoosiers about ready to score again. IU takes a back-to-back timeout here. Check out the yardage for the Hoosiers. 245 yards on the ground. Kentucky, 41.
That's unbelievable. Indiana's done a great job of coming in here and keeping the crowd quiet, Don. That's one of the goals you want to do when you go out on the road.
Now, Bill, what's Mallory going to say at halftime here? They've played well. They've given up 10 points, though. What do you think he's going to tell them?
He's going to get in there. He's going to try to get them cranked up like it's 0-0. He's going to get that team fired up. So when they come out and play, they're ready to go again.
All right. A good look here at Ditto. Has run this ball club down the field and has not thrown it once. Law, 22 is your tailback. And Lee is your up man.
You got the Mack truck in there.
All right, third and less than a yard. Quarterback sneak for Ditto. He may not have made that. Let's see what progress they give him. Well, that's a great shot on the field. And look here at Mallory with hands on hips. Good coverage tonight by our camera people. Good stuff, guys.
You know how many paces in the game? Look at him. He's leading the the whole team right there on the sidelines.
Now this time the official wants the timeout.
Pacey might sneak back in there, even though he's not supposed to. Look at him. He might go.
Look at that offensive line get out there. Klusmeyer, big guy. You know how big those guys are. Klusmeyer checks in at about 250, and he bounced off right there. Chris Ward, 47.
Klusmeyer was a great basketball player
first
in high school.
First down, IU. Yeah, he was. Big guy in the middle. First down for the Hoosiers. So we have first and goal now from the three. There's a look at Bill. It's churning inside, but he's looking calm from the outside. If IU scores on this set with a minute remaining in the half and clock running, they handled the ball five times and scored five touchdowns. Law looks like a touchdown, very close. It is Brett Law scoring for IU, and it's 34-10.
Again, the offensive line just dominating.
Well, Kentucky wasn't trying to fool anybody. They had a suspect defensive line. They had a lot of people. Yeah, we mentioned that it is his birthday, and he gets a nice little birthday present there. Number 22 is 23 today.
It's a nice birthday present.
Absolutely. Nice kid. We'll be out in Sheridan, by the way, next month as the grand marshal for their homecoming parade. Manilopoulos knocks it down. 35-10 IU, 48 seconds left, and we're back in a minute, first half. Ditto says this is easy.
At the half, it is 24, Tennessee 0.
Whoa!
Yes, yes, yes.
Gotcha, we can hear you, Calab.
All right, I'm going to scramble as soon as the gun sounds here.
All right, we can hear him.
All right, you guys be watching. I'll be fishing. All right.
David will send it right down to you. Now that was nice to stick another one in there. Another 7 points right before the half, so they could remember that a little bit. Now let's defend here with 48 seconds remaining in the first half. And we're ready to go. Manilopoulos to kick off. Rudolph, Sanford back. I think IU may have gotten the football. They did. Well, when you're ahead 35-10, you can do stuff like that.
I don't think that was intentional.
I don't think so either. Whoa, I'd like to see that one more time. Yeah, I'd like to see that one more time.
Monop was just trying to pooch it down there.
Smedley 18. Yeah, I think he was trying to pooch it, and he got a low pooch. And right into the front line of Kentucky. Well, an unexpected pleasure for the Hoosiers as Chris Ditto comes on again. He says, "Coach, you want me to throw?" Last series, he didn't get to put it in the air. And I bet you he doesn't right here either.
Indiana scored on all five possessions.
Isn't that a great stat?
Coach likes to see that.
Absolutely. I would too. Ball on the 47-yard line of IU with 43 seconds left in the half. Now Ditto is going to get to throw it. And he's going to get sacked at the 41-yard line.
He had pretty good time there. They had well, our receivers were well covered by Kentucky.
Clocks stopped at 34.
You got a penalty flag up there, Don.
Unsportsmanlike against Kentucky. Against Chris Ward, 47. Grabbing him right there.
First up out, Kentucky.
I thought maybe he might have grabbed his face mask. He did not yet. Well, I didn't see it there, did you?
That was a pretty good play.
I thought so, too.
That was a great play by the Kentucky defender.
Well, that's a bonus for the Hoosiers. I'm sure they're going to take it. Pacey out on the field says, "Get your buns down there, guys. Get ready to play. We only have 34 seconds left in the half."
Boy, is John into the game. Not out on the field, but he's on that sideline just cheerleading.
The ball is on the 44 of Kentucky. IU leading 35-10. Ditto to throw. It's good for Texas. Has his man and drops it. That looked like Stoner at the 30. It was.
Great protection by the offensive lineman.
Well, I wonder if the Jamu heard some patter of feet there.
Heard some footsteps.
You might have. I would not begrudge a man that, though, in the middle of the field with his back to a defender. I'd hear many footsteps. All right, it's a second and one.
Going back to the shotgun.
Second and one from the 44. And the official holding up play. We're ready to go now, he says. And the fans getting a little restless too here, especially since the majority of these folks are rooting for Kentucky and they're down 35-10. Look at all that blue in the crowd. Ditto. As his man far side, out of bounds. Was it Bruner? It was.
Ditto's pass complete to Bruner.
Again, he got great protection. You know, Ditto reminds me of Everett.
Steps out of bounds.
Reminds me of Everett. Got that strong arm, tall.
Hangs in there, too. No happy feet. And Bruner just waiting for that thing to arrive. The Ben Davis youngster gets what he can and steps out of bounds. Ryan at 6'3", a 200-pound sophomore, coming into this game, had caught four balls for an average of 7.3. So you can see he's caught a lot of balls just like that one, a possession receiver. Ditto again is sacked by Ward. Chris Ward, who had that penalty on him just a few moments ago, gets the sack with 6 seconds left.
Be interesting to see if Indiana's going to try for a field goal here.
Well, IU wanted to call that timeout because they wanted to see if they had good enough field position here to put three more points on the board, and Manolopoulos has the big toe.
I know Mono wants to get out there and try it.
Here he comes, number 90. Bill Mallory says, get out there, big fella. Let's see if we can get three more and negate the one that Kentucky got in the first half. IU leading 35-10. We'll catch Coach Mallory as he comes off the field here in the first half. Dave Calabro trying not to get trampled on the near sidelines when the Hoosiers rumble off. Well, they're taking a timeout here. That should have lasted 40 seconds in this situation. Well, let's see if they get back to it again. If you joined us late, you've missed a lot of good football here. 35-10 IU. We have just 6 seconds remaining here in the first half. And we have some news coming up for you at halftime from News Channel 13. So plenty of good stuff. Hang in from Lexington, Kentucky. And we'll see where they officially place this ball. 7 yards behind the line of scrimmage. And they'll put it on the 47-yard line. So let's see if it's a fake. Hang in. This would be, it's more than 54. Did he put it at the, well, Kentucky wants to make him think about it.
They want to make him think about it.
All right, let's take a break right here. We'll be right back. So much history out there with all the Civil War guys, and we're set to go. All right, Manolopoulos, let's see if you can make a 54-yard field goal here. This would be a career high for him. It's down and blocked.
That's
well, that
not going to make it.
That. Yeah, let's let the clock run out here. That's the end of the first half.
That's a good try.
35-10 IU, and let's send it down to Dave Calabro on the sidelines. David?
All right, Don, thanks for throwing it down to us right now. We're searching out the coach, Bill Mallory, here. Well, these guys are all fired up leaving the field right now. It's the Indiana Hoosiers with a strong first half of play, 250 yards plus on the ground. And here comes the coach now.
Yeah, well, again, the offense is doing a good job of good execution out there. And, you know, we got carried away on that where they got us from sportsmanlike conduct. And you just can't do that type of thing. You've got to, you know, have poise. But it's real key now that we can back out and play well the second half. And that's not what we did, you know, last week against Miami. So we've got to come back here and come right back at them again.
On the ground, 250 yards compared to Kentucky with less than 40.
Well, again, I'd just like to see the same thing done here the second half. Just play good, sound football.
We'll let you get into the locker room. Coach Bill Mowry joining us live here at Commonwealth Stadium. 35-10, the Indiana Hoosiers on their way to victory right now. We'll take you to break. More coming up at halftime. Stay with us.
Dominated defense, Kentucky's defense, and again, it's going to be important in the second half.
First downs, Don, 18 compared to 8.
Yeah, I was looking at the yardage for Kentucky.
Yeah.
Tape it. Matthews. All right.
All right.
Eric Matthews on the return. Mm-hmm.
Let's go, fellas. Stay in it here.
15,
okay.
Also on the stop, number 4, Littleton. All right.
Pizza Hut, when you order a medium smokehouse pizza for only $9.99. By Ameritech, we're designed around you. Ameritech, your link to better communication. By Society, Society, where to grow, a KeyCorp bank.
Commonwealth Stadium in Lexington, Kentucky. You missed one play. It was of little consequence unless you're Alex Smith. He picked up 10 yards on the first carry of the second half. We have a first down from the 40-yard line. He has 14 carries for 137 yards.
Wow.
13 for 137. Just underway second half. Thanks for joining us.
Boy, he's going to be fun to watch for the next 3 years.
All right. Here he is again to the near side, and they're just giving him huge holes. And the big hitter for Kentucky, Johnson, big hit him that time, and Alex went to
keeps those legs just to turning.
Pacey back in the ball game, and you were talking about his completion ratio and how he's going to stay atop the Big Ten.
In fact, he might be leading the nation next
right.
week.
Very efficient passing. That was one of our keys we talked about before the game. And look at that room to run. That must be exhilarating for Smith to see all that much open territory and to go right to it.
Some great blocking in the secondary, and as Coach Mowry told us, going to go in and tell those fellas that, hey, we're only halfway there.
This is a first from the 43. Just underway in the second half. First possession. Smith drops the ball. Recovered by Kentucky and picked up at the 50-yard line at the 48. It'll be Kentucky ball.
Well, it was his first turnover, and we talked about that at the beginning of the game. Alex got to learn to hold on to that ball.
Let's watch the replay and see if see who got the pop on him there. Take a look here, Joe.
George Harris got the pick for them. 92 made the tackle on that, really knocked it away. That's Robert Harris. And then George Harris gets the ball. He's the junior college transfer from Oakland, California. Getting congratulations from his teammates right there. And something like that can change a little momentum. Let's check it out for you. 35-10 IU, 13:48 left third quarter. O'Farrell to throw. Has a man wide open, Wyatt. He has it at the 23-yard line, and I mean wide open there, and picked off by Brown.
Down, they faked the option there, and the quarterback dropped back and threw over the middle.
Let's watch a replay here and see if they get sucked in on the fake. Can you see that, Joe?
I can't see the defensive back, but he was behind him. He comes up from behind him.
And Wyatt really was so wide open, he had to wait for the ball to come to him there. He was open a bunch. Now let's say first for Kentucky from the IU 23-yard line. 13 and a half minutes remaining third quarter. The fake again. O'Farrell up top. Rudolph, touchdown! So just as IU had scored in two plays in the first half, Kentucky says take that one on the chops, and they come right back with the turnover for 6 points.
Well, one of the keys to the game that we mentioned coming into this was the fact that they would have to challenge the young IU secondary, and obviously in the second half, that's exactly what's going on here. Rudolph, who is a world-class speedster, in fact, in the SEC, the 200-meter champ. So Clyde Rudolph wide open.
All right, that changed very, very quickly, didn't it? Kavinsky, extra point, kicks it out of the stadium, and with 13 minutes and 21 seconds remaining in the third quarter, wham bam from Kentucky, 35-17, and we're back in the run-up and the boot. And Jermaine Chaney is back there. Likewise, He has a little help. Now the Hoosiers bring it across the 20 to the 23-yard line.
Down that touchdown brought the crowd back into it.
It sure did. Eric Matthews brings it up. He has some world-class speed also. 35-17 now. Now, we were kind of analyzing what Kentucky had done differently in that set. Really, they hadn't. They just ran the play-action series, and they had two wide-open people. John Pacey coming back in the ball game. You see his numbers on the mic. Perfect. 60 yards. Ditto has the only incomplete pass. So Matthews to the far side. Beatty to the near. Lee the up man. Smith the tailback, and naturally they give it right back to him. It was he who fumbled on the last go round. You like to get it right back in the belly of the kid again who made the mistake. Get a little confidence there. David Snarden, 48 on the tackle for Kentucky. 13 minutes left in the third quarter here. Quick Kentucky touchdown, 35-17.
Oh, the Mack truck just knocked somebody out there.
Who was
a heck of a block.
Who was the lead blocker there, the fullback?
Lee.
Beautiful.
Steve Lee is a moose.
You saw
250, and he did cover it up.
Yeah, he put two hands on the ball.
I had a second and three from the 28 for the Hoosiers. Smith again. He's not going to get the first on that one. Snarden again on the stop, 48.
That was a good fill by their linebacker. He met Lee head on, stayed low, and then was able to make the tackle.
This Kentucky defense kind of looks like a whole different unit from the first half.
Really does. All you need is a couple of plays to get him excited again. Snarden from Louisville Male High School, a junior, and there's Alex, stood up and brought down very quickly.
Kentucky defense doing a good job there. Snarden doing a good job fighting off that lead block.
Third and two for the Hoosiers at the 29. Leading 35-17 early in the third quarter. Pacey keeps it. First down. Nice play, John, across the 30 to the 35-yard line. And Melvin Johnson again makes the stop. So not only has Pacey gotten some decent yardage tonight, he's gotten important yardage. He's gotten a couple of touchdowns and several first down yardages, too. So Pacey playing a nice, heady ball game here.
Great to have a smart quarterback running the option. And John is just an intelligent individual. He can pick the holes, knows when to pitch it or when to run it.
There you see his numbers, an average of six on the night. First from the 35. And across the 35 to about the 34-yard line.
John Pacey's family and friends, all his aunts and uncles were in town last week. They said they'd be watching this game on the satellite tonight in Huntington, New York.
Welcome.
Having some pizza. His uncles were making the za last weekend down there at IU.
All right, Glover had the carry the last time around. We have to mention that. He doesn't get it too often. A second and eight. A gain of two there for Sean from the 37-yard line. And we're at the 11-minute mark here in the third quarter. 35-17 IU. Led 35-10 at the half. Pacey plenty of time. Gets rid of it. That's incomplete. I think more anything, he just got rid of the ball. Kind of in the vicinity was a Johnny Stoner. And Pacey was trying to get a hold call, I think, on somebody.
That was questionable about being a pass interference there. Very close.
As we're talking about a lot about the IU rushing attack, of course, that's been the subject all night long. Last year, they only did it three times, having a 100-yard game. They've had three in a row to start the season here.
Look at that. Indiana 6-for-6 on third down conversions.
Third and eight from the 37. Pacey threw it behind Matthews.
He was open.
He was there. Now that's the first unsuccessful third down for the Hoosiers tonight. So Kentucky's credit, they make him give it up. This is the first time we've seen Jim DiGiulio to punt.
Lost his footing here, and our guys bring up a good point on the turf. May have had that ball.
First punt for Jimmy tonight. Of course, he's all Big Ten the last couple of years.
He took the first half off.
Oh, beauty.
Oh, nice kick.
Sanford at the 15, 14. He had a good shot at him there and missed him. 20, 25, 30, and that's it. Sanford at the 31. Let's take this timeout. We're right back.
Exactly. Yep. Exactly. That's different, isn't it? Right.
Which is a great place to have it. Ooh, no.
Well, at least we have a good TV game going here. I know you IU types are not liking it.
Just had a penalty.
Take a peek right here. Sanford almost broke this one. Got by Goody there. And just a little trip, and you can see how angry he was that he got that little trip. Ware right on top of him there, number 9. We're set to go. Illegal procedure on the last set by IU. Refused, obviously, by Kentucky. They take over on downs. First and 10 from their own 31-yard line, trailing 35-17, 10 and a half minutes remaining in the third quarter. Wyatt in motion to the far side. The pitch is for Williams. We haven't heard his name for a while. And he gets out of that big mess there to his credit and gets almost back to the line of scrimmage.
That was an excellent effort.
Hammerstein and Drake make the stop. Nice pursuit by IU. They hung in there well.
Surprised to see Kentucky come back out in the I set, or the I set. I figure they come back out in the pro set trying to run up some
points. Yeah, why
points.
Is that, Joe? When it's when they're successful doing something, why don't they come right back and pound it right in again?
I don't know, Don. Well, I'm not coaching. Yeah. But I look for them to come back out to their spread set again.
I would certainly try to make them stop. What was
back
working
in the
well.
Eye.
All
back
right.
In the eye. Exactly.
Here we go. Second and 12 from the 29. This time Wyatt is to the near side. And O'Farrell will throw. As an incomplete pass, almost intercepted by Al Thomas. That would have been his third interception of the year. Had that big one last week, 97 yards, which is third in IU history. Look at O'Farrell.
The four-man front seems to be getting more pressure now, Joe.
Yeah, it looked like Trevor Wilmot got in there and put some pressure on the quarterback. That's a key. You got to put pressure on that quarterback.
Make him hurry.
We have a third down, gentlemen. A third down and 12 yards from the 29. 35-17 IU. Rudolph coming to the near side. 9.5 minutes remaining third quarter. And the Wildcats try to spread IU out again, and they go into that zone. O'Farrell looks to near side, throws far, and Williams cannot hold on. Good defense from IU. That should be an incomplete pass. It is. We have an IU man down in the field momentarily too, but
it's Pinnock. Watch the heat Pinnock puts on the quarterback right here.
Pressure.
And he delivers the hit. Pretty serious hit.
But they'll have to give up the ball, and IU will have a chance to do some heavy damage here again, because they're going to get it at least, I would think, at the 30-yard line. That's where Eddie Beatty is right now, waiting for this one to come down from Nicky Nichols. Nice punt. Almost up into the lights. Beatty at the 23, the 25, 30, 35, 36-yard line. Nice run back on the punt by Eddie Beatty. 35-17 IU. Back in a minute. We're back again. Back in action, mid-run, Alex Smith, 30, 25, he's going to go all the way. We're going to have that one on replay for you. Alex Smith, one play all the way from the 37-yard line. 63 yards for Alex Smith.
Alex showed his speed on this play.
Oh, take a peek at this one right here, up close and personal from Alex Smith.
Gets a couple of key blocks, kicks to the outside, and
breaks a tackle,
got a little help on a miss there, and turns it upfield. And like you said, Joe, look at the speed.
That speed.
That's exactly what happens when Johnson didn't wrap up on the tackle there, hit him with the shoulders and didn't wrap.
Pointed out earlier, these guys do a lot of arm tackling early on. He just did a nice job breaking his way through both.
Manolopoulos down the pipe, 42-17 IU. Well, that puts a little fear back in the Wildcats' heart again. There's a look at Alex, 8:58 left third quarter, and we're back in a second. Good.
Yeah.
Absolutely, I would think so too.
That hurt him right there.
Does Mallory get involved with the players at this point in the ballgame? Does he depend on his assistants, or does he get in there too?
Well, right now he wants to keep those players fired up. I think if the key things keep going the way it is, he's going to pull in some of the younger guys.
Alex Smith breaking free. Clay Williams with a key block right there. Smith now 18 carries, 225 yards, and two touchdowns. Indiana with 360 yards. Alex Smith, definitely the player of the game right now.
IU getting near what I think is near an all-time high at 42 points. As Kentucky brings it back, that is Rudolph back across the 20 to the 24-yard line.
I don't think we're going to see Alex. I don't know if Coach will put him back in or who he's going to put in, but Alex had a pretty busy night already.
It's amazing to see him use his speed and strength.
Lane Oxley on the stop, by the way, for IU from Kendall, Indiana. And here comes Kentucky again. Let's see what formation they'll show this time. They'll show the spread again on the first from the 24-yard line. Jermaine Ware in the defensive backfield for IU. Back in there with Smedley. Pitch to the near side. Keep O'Farrell across the 35 to the 37-yard line. That's enough for the first down. And the gentleman we were just talking about, Jermaine Ware, made the stop. Well, I'll tell you what, in this kind of a ball game, I wouldn't think that they would be able to stick that long with the option.
That's true.
Trying to run the option out of the shotgun there.
Yeah, that was straight at it. First from the 37-yard line. We have 8.5 minutes remaining third quarter, 42-17 IU. Big play of the game, a 63-yarder from, nice catch.
Beauty.
Excellent catch by Smith from O'Farrell at the 50-yard line.
Again, Don, they go right in the middle. I mean, I'm surprised those receivers haven't got popped yet.
Hey, like that, a Louisville boy playing down here in Lexington.
Well, and here's an oddity, too. You see if there's anything odd about Smith for a receiver when you see him right there. He doesn't wear gloves. I can't believe it. I've never seen a receiver these days without gloves. That one stuck, didn't it? Maybe he has stick him on his hands, which is also illegal.
Let's go check that out.
Yeah, go down in the field and check that out. First and 10 from the 50 for Kentucky. Right at the 8-minute mark. Pitch out there to Williams, who handles it nicely. Good play from Moe across the 40, down to the 39, maybe the 38. John Hammerstein runs the play down and makes the stop. The big lineman followed the play. Watch this. This is really a bad pitch here. He was just protecting life and limb when he got rid of that one.
Very dangerous.
Moe chopped it out of midair.
Turned nothing out into something right here. 12 yards.
I tell you, that John Hammerstein, that guy plays with heart. I played against his brothers at Michigan, and they were tough. Hammerstein came in. He's a little bit undersized, but he's put some weight on himself. But I'll tell you, he is a hard worker.
Had a brother played for the Bengals. The Hammer.
Yep, that's the right. Hammer.
Ball on the 38, first down for Kentucky. Trailing 42-17. Farrell intended for Rudolph. Covered over there, kind of, by Wilmot. You know, this is the kind of a game that you really have to be careful, not only from the broadcasting side, but from the playing side, that you have so much of a cushion here for one team. It's easy to lose concentration both as a player and a broadcaster, so we'll try to work on it from our side if they try from their side.
Is that true for you, Joe, when you were playing?
Yeah, the thing about when you get up by a big score, coach is going to put in the younger guys. And I think that's what you're going to see if they score again, or at least into the fourth quarter.
But it's Kentucky. Don't you want to run the score up?
Well, not Mallory, I wouldn't say. That's Rudolph again on the completion. Yeah. And again, Jermaine Moore makes the stop. I don't think we're in the running up stage here yet, do you?
No.
We still have plenty of time left in the ball game, and if they get a couple of scores, I mean, you've got a contest again. And
they're moving the ball nicely right now.
Good fake by O'Farrell.
First down, Kentucky.
From the 24-yard line, 7 minutes and 13 seconds remaining third quarter. Ball on the 24, 42-17, IU. Coming up next week, Badgers of Wisconsin at Wisconsin. That's a good tester right there. 3-0 into that one, and then the good tester.
Middle!
And it's to Williams.
Had him stopped at the line of scrimmage.
Yeah.
Didn't wrap him up.
Where's made the last three tackles? And that might have been a touchdown saver right there.
Let's see what the line had him right here.
That's a gain of about 8 yards.
Mo just makes the nice move through there.
Didn't know he was there.
Yeah. That was Nathan Davis.
Didn't know he was even there. Turn around. So there's the ball carrier.
Ware and Warnicke knew he was there, and Mallory's into it. He knew he was there. So from the 15-yard line, we have a second and one. 6 minutes, 10 seconds left, third quarter. Same setup. Williams, your eye back. And the fake to him. O'Farrell keeps pressure from backside, breaks that. 12, 10, 5 yard line, and he's out of bounds.
And Indiana put the pressure on him. They just lost the container.
Yep, Lance Brown ran him out.
They had him cornered. Watch Troy Drake on this play. 66 is a. They bring the house right here. Turns it into an 11-yard first down.
Just got out.
Three different guys. This is a beautiful move by the quarterback.
He is basically a runner, and he showed you right there. They moved him to safety last year. They thought they had enough quarterbacks. Then Speedy got hurt. Last year, Pookie Jones got hurt for him, and he had to come into the ball game. And finally, he's at his spot that he likes to be. O'Farrell, an option quarterback, 42-17. We have a first and goal from the four for Kentucky. Farrell swings it out here. It's incomplete. Took it on the first hop. That's Carter.
The coach is still intense. This guy's down there with his hands on his knees. He's into it. He doesn't want him to score.
He's one of those guys you mentioned Kentucky to him, and his lather goes up, doesn't it?
Gordon 28, Carter 29. So it'll be second and goal from the 4 yard line. Second and goal from the four, and the 58,000 that were with us at the get-go are still with us. Even though the Hoosiers lead the Wildcats 42-17 at the 5:50 mark of the third quarter. Wing back in motion. Gordon, hand to Williams. He looks like he has a real touchdown. That's right. Mo Williams with the touchdown for Kentucky.
Indiana's just not tackling.
Not wrapping them up, are they, Joe? Here's the replay for you. Breaks it outside.
His arm tackled.
Lance Brown was the last one to touch him there at the goal line, but Mo had enough momentum to go in.
Arm tackling because they're tired or not concentrated? Order either one of those applied, Joe.
Kentucky has not given up. Right when you think that they're going to be put down, they keep coming back in.
42-24 IU, 5 minutes and 41 seconds left, third quarter, and we're back in a minute. And 41 seconds left in the quarter, and we have timeout again. IU taking it. They were ill-prepared for this one. They want a timeout to talk about setup.
They had three backs in the backfield. I don't know if Indiana has practiced against that, but Kentucky came out with the first time tonight, three backs in the backfield.
We were just taking a look at the stats, and we'll talk more about that. But first, the timeout. Stay with us. Indiana leads 42-23.
That's the life of the Rose Bowl.
Between the two teams.
Guys, you were just checking the record books there. What do we have?
Well, Don, in 1969, Indiana won 56-30, so it's a total of 86 points scored by both teams. And of course, Indiana won the game by the score of 56-30.
Lead the series at 15-8-1. But they've lost 4 out of 5 here, and boy, it's feeling good right now to them.
This is the only series that Indiana leads. They do not even lead in the Big Ten over any team. In fact, they need four more to go surpass Northwestern.
That's a good stat for you. Here's that three men in the backfield again. Actually four if you're going to count the quarterback, and you better. He wants to change the play again.
Got an audible going.
O'Farrell on the triple option. He ain't going to make it. And he fumbles it. That ought to be the end of the play right there on the recovery in the end zone. Nice play by Louis Panache.
He read it the entire way, didn't he?
I think he had the quarterback the whole way. I think that was his assignment.
That was his assignment. Okay.
Well, I think that the pros are finally getting some of the good collegiate rules into their ranks with the two-point conversion.
Put a little bit more spice into it, a little bit more excitement.
Well, high school football season is heating up. Of course, you can catch the best in Friday Night Football with Operation Football on News Channel 13, 6 and 11 on Friday nights. Of course, we'll have crews all over Central Indiana on the ground and, of course, in Chopper 13. Operation Football, Fridays at 6 and 11 on News. Calling it out. We noticed a moment ago that John Pacey was down congratulating the defense for the fine job they did. You always like to see that. An O guy talking to the D guys and keeping them at it.
That doesn't happen very often. Usually there's so much separation between the offense and the defense. Half the time, they never meet.
He's definitely the team leader.
All right. 42-23, IU's advantage with 5 minutes and 41 seconds remaining here in the third quarter. And this guy has gotten a little bit of work tonight here too, hasn't he, huh? In addition to Manilopoulos, Savinsky, number 41, has gotten more than his share of work. As a matter of fact, he got his first field goal as a collegian in the first half when he knocked down a 48-yarder. There's going to be a run back on this one on the far side, and it's Matthews at the 5. 20, 25, and the 30-yard line. Well, it's nice to see some of those white jerseys getting a little dark at about this time in the night, huh? That's what's nice about the good turf. That's real football.
That's
huh?
Right.
The jerseys get dirty.
You can tell a real football player if you play on that grass, they'll come back in and they'll have those grass stains and mud all over them.
Came in today and saw that rain. Everybody was kind of excited about that since they're playing on the real stuff.
Well, let's see how the Hoosiers react to that last set. A first from the 30. And Pacey brings him out in the eye with Matthews to the near side, and the hand is to Brett Long. Brett, great yardage across the 40 to the 43-yard line. Plenty enough for the first down. Well, they're chewing him up, aren't they?
Law showed his speed, too. Well, he's quick.
What an adjustment he had to make this year, you guys. First starting out on the defense and then flipping back over and finds the corner here, Joe.
He's a running back. Look at him. Look at the blocking there.
Right tackle right with a nice block.
He is one of those guys who runs with abandon. He had that ball flailing all over the place. First from the 44. Good numbers for IU. A first and 10 from the 44. 42-23. Is he going to make it? Yeah, he made it around the corner, but just by the skin of his teeth on that one across the 45 to the 48-yard line. And so he turned a potential loss into a three-yarder. And the tackle by Stephen Hall, the left cornerback, making the stop for Kentucky. How much talking is there, Joseph, between these two teams out there? Is there a little nose-to-nose stuff?
No, it's been a pretty hard-fought game. I haven't seen anything come up yet.
Maybe just so the officials can't hear it, huh?
Yeah.
Second and 6 from the 48. 4.5 left, third quarter. Cheney made that one himself across the 45, the 41-yard line. Plenty for the first down for the Hoosiers.
IU averaging 287 on the ground coming into this game. I never thought that they'd turn it out like this.
Boy, their offensive line has gotten so much better this year. A lot stronger, quicker.
Oh, almost lost the football there, and Jermaine Kempton and then Snarden came up for the stop right there. So from the 41-yard line, we have another IU first down with 4 minutes and 10 seconds remaining third quarter. Cheney again, near side this time, 40, 35, 33, down to the 32, 1 yard line possibly. And on the stop, the good block, I should say, Clay Williams on the near side making the block. Watch him right here. Watch for big number 78 making the hold-off block right there. Just seals his man right off, and Cheney makes it around the corner.
And Brian Bruner downfield making a nice block to give him a couple extra yards as well.
I think with the addition with Alex, being a great running back that he is, he's made Chaney and also Law better. He's taking them to their top potential.
Second and one from the 31. This time it's Law, the tailback, right up the gut.
You talk about a great cutback. You talk about vision, Law. Law had his vision on there.
All right, that's another first for IU, and they'll place the ball at the 24-yard line where Stephen Hall made the stop for the Wildcats. Well, if you're on the road, this is what you like for the opposition, a nice quiet crowd so you can hear your plays, and they're calling out run almost every time down. There's a look at Brett right there, sports management, a fifth-year senior from Sheridan, Indiana.
Celebrating birthday 23 today.
You got Chaney back in.
Check it, guys. 406 yards on the night. Wow. Over the 400 mark. Here's Chaney as they come back with a triple threat. Chaney across the 20-yard line down to the 19. And the stop is made by Reggie Rusk, number two, the number two man at free safety. We're at the 19-yard line on a second and five. 2:43 clock running, remaining third quarter. 42-23 IU.
And IU linebacker, the old man, Joe Huff in the booth with us tonight. We just want to ask you about Brett Law and Smith. What's the difference between the two here? What makes Alex such a different player?
Well, I think they're both great running backs. Alex came in. He's got, I think, that additional speed and that heart. I mean, he comes in. He's got great work ethic.
That's Law. Down to the 10.
And, you know, both of them are great running backs. It's just that Alex is the number one running back. And again, I think he's brought Law to that next level
because of his work ethic.
His work ethic. Sorry. Yeah, and I think he's just pushed him up to his level where he needs to be.
All right, from Chopper 13, the shot, and they said he stepped out at the 12-yard line, and that's where the Hoosiers will have it, first and 10. Pacey calling a good game here tonight. Anytime he has the option to call for the audible, and he called his number right there, and it was heard by the opposition. A gain of a yard maybe on that play. Ginn, the tackler, 44.
Here's a replay from our field camera.
Nice play by Ginn here. Really, he came up and got the man he was assigned to.
He went up there and tattooed him. That's a Mallory phrase.
Tattooed him?
Yeah, tattooed him. He had his jaw locked.
Second and 10 from the 12. Hoosiers leading 42-23. We have just a minute 35 remaining in the third quarter. Hoosiers led 35-10 at the halftime. Kentucky came right back and scored on him. Pacey's option, keeps it again. Touchdown, John Pacey.
And he had a hole.
He had one man to beat, and he just put his head down and said, this one's mine. The free safety, Reggie Rusk, met him at the goal line. Look at Pacey having a great time.
Boy, that's number three. That's his third touchdown?
Third touchdown of the night, boy. John Pacey.
Al Pacey came into this ball game with one rushing touchdown.
Watch him put his head down again, right here. Just take it on in. Look at that.
Whoa. I know,
like
this
a fullback.
The defensive coordinator for Kentucky has got to be concerned with 73 points last week, and now they're up to 49.
Manolopoulos knocks it down. IU's lead is 49-23. A minute 22 left in the third quarter, and we're back in a minute. The running backs come up to them and tell them how much they appreciate what they're done.
Here's your scoring drive, and here's the replay. Pacey says, this is all mine. Puts his head down and bumps his way in there for his third touchdown of the night.
All right, Sanford and Carter back now for Kentucky. That was a 9-play, 70-yard drive, only 3 minutes and 19 seconds. The 12-yard run by Pacey for the 6. Here's the rushing situation. Smith with 225. Chaney almost 100-yard night. He has 90. Law with 71. And Pacey with 47 for 430.
And it's the third quarter.
Three running backs approaching. One of them over 100. Two other.
This
knocking on 100.
And Pacey with 3 TDs. And Law with 1. Smith with a couple.
Top of your screen here, right there. See the red? That's where all the IU fans are tonight. They've been on their feet most of the night.
Joe Dillon, the chopper pilot up there. Great job tonight, Joseph. Great camera work also. 49-23 IU. That is Sanford at the 10. He coughs up the football. IU has it again, it looks like, on the 24.
Wow. Indiana scores here. They're going to be the all-time scoring leader.
Look out now. Game. Well, who is on the bottom of that pile there to get that ball?
Had a host.
Does
up.
It Let's Ben your Jones? Replay. All right.
Here's the replay. Blocker set up for him here.
Well, a fairly decent block. Pretty good play off the block. I think he knocked it off his own man there,
or
didn't he?
Like somebody may have gotten a hand in there at the last second.
Yeah, Benyard on the bottom of that pile with the... Yeah, and he's getting congratulations from his teammates right over here. Nice job for the big guy, number 67.
UK fans are pouring out of the stadium, and you can hear the IU fans chanting that.
And we're right back at it again. Oh, nice run
great
by
run.
Law.
Great run. Kept his legs going.
Down to the 10-yard line.
I can't believe all these people leaving.
I have to think if the Hoosiers score quickly here again that Bill will go with some of his young players.
Here's the replay.
I don't know if Bill brought six running backs.
Oh. After three, we're going to have to go to the numerical roster, guys. I'll tell you what, we have two deep here. All right, this time again, Steve Lee is the up man. What a blocker he's been all night. He still hasn't gotten the ball yet. And this time, we're going to go nowhere. Didn't fake anybody out on that one at all.
Might have had a little problem on the exchange there.
Kentucky's constricting their defense because of the run. They expect us to run. We might have to throw a pass here just for them to respect us.
Good point. Travel limitations, so a lot of the young players are still in Bloomington. Wishing they were here tonight.
You get that whirly bird up there and back, a couple
probably
players.
Could.
If you're at home, you can dress the world, can't you?
Yeah. Yeah. Dress everybody.
Yeah. But when you're on the road, little expenses involved there. All right, it's Cheney again. Good move down to the 10, maybe the 9-yard line.
Cheney on the carry.
All right, that's the end of the third quarter. IU leads at 49-23 over Kentucky.
But we just got the, well, if we score here, give us what? 50.
Tonight's Indiana University football game is brought to you in part by Pizza Hut. You'll fall in love again with Pizza Hut when you order a medium smokehouse pizza for only $9.99. By Ameritech, we're designed around you. Ameritech, your link to better communication. By Society, Society, where to grow, a KeyCorp bank.
And we're back live. We're back live. Commonwealth Stadium, the Indiana Hoosiers are just a touchdown and an extra point away from tying their all-time high mark against Kentucky. 56 points, the most they scored way back in 1969.
I'll tell you what, we have our stat man Bob Bernath as you look at John Pacey right there working overtime with all of those numbers. He's been writing like mad here the entire ball game.
John wants some more points.
49-23 as we start the fourth quarter. And Matthews coming to the near side in motion. Ditto's pass is knocked out of midair, incomplete.
Ditto's 6'6", 6'7". That guy had a hit his arm pretty high up there.
Yeah, that was Lehman Boyd, 15. And Kentucky still working at it.
Look at the stats here. Wow. 225 yards for Alex.
That's a deuce in the quarter.
Like Pacey, yeah. Pacey's got the least yards, but he's got the most touchdowns. 27 yards, 3 TDs.
Bragging,
yeah.
Boy, some great numbers there. All right, from the 27-yard out, here's a possible three, and...
Ooh.
Is it good? It is. So Manolopoulos has his first field goal of the night. Now they're probably talking about that one, huh? We'll talk about it when we come back. 52-23 IU, 14:50 left, and we'll see you in a minute.
You can call me Kevin. I wish I was making this money.
You know, what was it? Indiana going 240 points, like one.
This copyrighted telecast is intended solely for the private, non-commercial use of our viewing audience. Any publication, reproduction, retransmission, or other use of the pictures, descriptions, and accounts of this game without the expressed written consent of the Big Ten, Raycom, or WTHR is prohibited. 14:50 left. The Indiana Hoosiers on top of Kentucky. 52-23 your score, Don.
Looking at big Chris Smith there, number 71, just a second ago on the sidelines. He had a brother who used to play for the Bengals too, David.
Yes.
All right, the kickoff, 14:50 left, and it's in the end zone. You better cover it, guys, and they finally do. Rudolph says, let's take it right there, and we'll go out to the 20-yard line.
And things don't get any easier for Kentucky next week. You know, USA Today rated their schedule the 10th strongest coming into the season. They have South Carolina next week and then Auburn. So Kentucky hurting right now.
Wisconsin needs to be concerned with Indiana going up there. Traditionally, Indiana has played well at Wisconsin, and also they play well on ESPN. Again, that game's going to be 11:30 game on ESPN.
Hey, guys, next tomorrow, actually, on the Huddle Show, we'd like to remind you we have a good show for you at 11 o'clock. We'll tell you about it in just a second right after this Kentucky play. We have Jason Belzer on, and that's at 11 o'clock tomorrow morning. We'll update you and get you ready for the Pittsburgh game. I'll be in Pittsburgh for that one, so join us live from Steeler Country tomorrow. O'Farrell has his man Wyatt. And they're going to have him down at the 46-yard line. Nice play with 14:41 left in the ball game.
Play covers 27 yards.
27-yard play. Here it is. I haven't heard that in a while, have we?
No, the announcer's still fired up.
They just wind him up for the ball game and let him go. They don't care what the score is, huh? O'Farrell making the call. Tough job for a quarterback in this situation, trying to keep his team up. Down 52-23 with 14.5 left in the ball game. IU has been unstoppable on the ground tonight, leading 35-10 at the half. Scored on their first five possessions. O'Farrell brings it out to the far side to Smith, across the 50, down to the 47-yard line.
That kind of sums it up, scoring on your first five possessions.
It really does.
Well, Don, with you flying off to Pittsburgh tomorrow, you get some frequent flyer mileage in here.
You better be here. I'll be at the frequent flyer mileage there for about, I almost forgot last time when we went to Tampa Bay. That's a nice deal, isn't it?
There's the numbers on O'Farrell, 191 yards.
That's a pretty good night for him, 14 for 25.
Yeah, he's having a good night.
But when you see the big numbers like that for O'Farrell, you got to know that Kentucky's losing, because that is not their ball game at all. They're a running ball club, and if they can't run, you're going to beat them. There's a flag. IU was offside on the play.
Better cover him.
And O'Farrell makes the first down anyway. Down to the 31-yard line.
I've been really impressed with this Indiana defense, especially, you know, early in the first half.
They've surprised a lot of people. I think they'll have a big check next week.
All right, they obviously refused the Indiana offside. They have it at first at the 32-yard line.
Looked like a couple of players just stopped. I didn't know if they were waiting for a whistle or what, but they should have got in a little quicker.
Never do that. Always play, huh?
How do you hear that whistle?
All right, here we go. From the 32-yard line, a first for the Kentucky Wildcats. 13-13 left. They trail 52-23. Williams across the 25, down to the 23-yard line. Almost enough for the first down. Still a lot of the blue of Kentucky with us here.
The true fans are still here.
And I'll guarantee you, All those in red are over there in the corner. Yeah, they want to see the end of this one.
Joe, you work in the alumni department, correct?
Correct.
You planned a big party for everybody tonight, about 500 strong?
Well, we had one for the pregame. We had a lot of our clubs come down and a lot of the alumni in the area here and all the ticket holders. We had a good party.
Always a good party when it's IU, right?
Always when there's red.
Second and one. That's to Williams on the pitch from O'Farrell. And he has plenty for the first down across the 15 to the 12-yard line. IU leading 52-23, 12:25 left in the ball game.
That's a gain of 11 yards. Or another.
Coming right at you.
Kentucky.
Quarterback is quick.
Yeah, he is. He is a quick little guy.
Well, he's got a gear. Well, he took a hit there.
But the operative word, I think, is little. And if you're going to throw the ball at all, you better be able to see over the lineman. All right, Bo Williams, still your tailback. And the up back hood. Williams again across the 10. Nice effort to the 8-yard line. And the tackler again is Troy Drake. IU going with its first defensive unit with help from Lance Brown.
Coach is getting on him out there. Look at him. Saying, fire up, guys. It's not over. Look at him.
We had him fired up before the ball game when he was talking about the intensity of this one. He said, you want to remember Kentucky and Purdue.
Yeah, he says that. Kentucky. He gets a little emphasis on that.
All right, second and seven from the 9-yard line. 11 and a half left. And O'Farrell hands again to Williams, far side. And a bad tackle there by Warnicki. Ran right through the arms. And Panak makes the stop.
Warnicki had him dropped for a loss back there.
Watch those arm tackles. Got to wrap him up.
Panak checking in at 6'1", 250, just a junior from Hartford, Connecticut. And Goody checking in along with Ellum. And Warnicki coming out.
Going back in the shotgun.
All right, a little man-for-man coverage here on the near side with Rudolph and Smith. O'Farrell brings it down, yeah. Ooh. Intended for Wyatt at about the 10-yard line. He had a couple people open. And got it just a little bit high. So with 10 minutes and 37 seconds remaining in the ball game, it's going to be a fourth down and 10. Three would make obviously no difference here.
Yeah, they got to go for it.
Everybody go deep on three, break.
Draw this one in the turf. Huh?
Backyard football. They're all saying, I'm going to be open.
I can beat this guy.
Yeah, looking for me across the middle.
And intended for Smith on the far side, and IU will take over at the 12-yard line on down. All right, so the Hoosiers still have their concentration going here. Let's take a break with 10:29 left and IU leading 52-23.
I'm ready. Look at all the folks pouring now, man.
59. And Clay Williams, 78, going for the second unit right now. Second and three from the 19 for the Hoosiers. Second and three. And an official timeout. Apparently he blew his whistle. And it didn't blow. And he went for whistle number two. Have any of you guys, go ahead. Yeah, tell me about that, Joseph. You were talking about that before.
I was just looking at the program goals. When I was a freshman, when we had a 0-11 season, Coach Malley got our team together that next year, and we came up with some program goals, and I'd like to mention them right now. Number one, earn an IU degree. Two, win the Big Ten championship. And three, win the trophy games. Of course, this is the Bourbon Barrel being one of the trophy games, the Old Oak Bucket and the Spittoon being the other.
All right, here's the hand of Cheney coming to the near side. Ditto your quarterback now.
That Bourbon Barrel was down on the sidelines down there. The trainers were protecting that like it was gold.
They got that on the sideline. One of the worst things as a player that you can do, if you lose, you walk as a senior, You walk that over to the other team's locker room, and I know Indiana doesn't want to do that tonight.
IU has all the trophies from all the games right now.
All the trophies. Spittoon and the bucket.
Spittoon with Michigan State.
Uh-huh. Bucket's got too many peas on it, though, so we're happy to keep that as many times as possible.
That one coming up at the end of the year, as always.
It's good to have a rival early in the season, also at the end.
And the Hoosiers next week will be in Wisconsin. This is Cheney again. Check it, it's Law 22. Law carrying, Cheney carrying, Smith carrying. Cheney has 15 for 102 wow. tonight. 15 carries for 102, and Law should be getting near that 100 mark too.
Brett Law, who broke 1,000 career yards last week, makes a nice run here and got up and was giving a little lip service to his teammates here. Say, I'm having fun out here. Keep giving me the pigskin.
He's saying, keep me in, coach.
Kearney to the far side, Bruner to the near side for Chris Ditto with one man in the backfield. That would be Law. Ball's on the 33 on a second and one. IU leading 52-23 at the 8:25 mark. And Law right up the gut for the first down across the 35 to the 36-yard line.
Brett Law was telling us, Don, that his probably number one memory from playing at IU was last year when he came off the bench against Iowa and put up 140 yards rushing.
Yeah, that was a good gutty performance too, because he hadn't been called on for a while too, and come off and give that kind of a performance.
Had to wait about 6 weeks, didn't he?
Yeah. All right, Stoner going to the far side this time, and Bruner to the near. And this time it's Jermaine Cheney, your running back. Right at the 8 minute mark here in the fourth quarter, 52-23 IU, and Ditto gives to Cheney, who bellies to the far side. 40, 35, check it, 50. Yeah, he's out of bounds, maybe at the 48-yard line.
Those running backs are still running hard. You know, Law's got the stadium record for at Indiana Memorial State. He had 240 yards in 1992 when we played Missouri.
No containment whatsoever here.
Almost a block in the back there, too.
He's got him clipped there.
Nice little head shake there.
All right. 481 yards on the night, says Bob Burnett. We're almost to the 500 mark. First and 10 from the 50 for the Hoosiers. And Cheney makes that one himself. He may break it. 40, 35, 30. Jermaine Cheney's going to go all the way, and he should have been gotten at the line of scrimmage. What balance from Jermaine Cheney.
And Cheney showed his speed.
And he takes the helmet off. You're going to have to get a shot at Cheney when he takes the helmet off, huh? All right, what a run, and there are the IU fans.
Man.
Nice job, Hoosiers.
Watch him duck here. I don't need the tackler. Look at that. He stopped.
Squeezing right under there. Had his momentum stop and just hung on. Wow.
Jermaine Cheney. Wow.
Indiana breaking the scoring record here against Kentucky. 58-23 with 7 minutes and 34 seconds left to play.
What would be a nice stat, guys, is to look when the last time was that two guys had over 100 yards in the game for the Hoosiers. Manilopoulos knocks it down, 59-23 Hoosiers with 7.5 minutes left. And we're back in a minute.
What's our total on rushing?
Yeah. Hey, you hear that? When we throw the break, wait a couple seconds because they got to pull our mics in. Yeah, they're getting our audio. So just wait about 5 seconds. What are you looking at
six
now?
Six plays, 88. How many does Law have? How many yards does Law have?
Is this for a team?
Law has
474.
474 was the record win?
Versus Northwestern, 1988.
What's our career? What's the team total rushing?
538.
That's a record.
531.
That's a record.
531.
Record.
Here we go, guys. Here we go. No, they're under okay. The Hoosiers with 531 yards on the night. That is a record. And here's the man who put him over the top, Jermaine Cheney.
A new school record going back to 1988 against the Northwestern. They had 574, 531 yards on the ground as we kick the ball off to Kentucky.
And this is Rudolph with the action up at the 35-30 to the 32-yard line. Well, Brett Law has 96 yards on the night, guys, so we could have three 100-yard rushers. There's Jermaine. Say hi, Jermaine.
Thank you. Well, prime time there for you. Most points ever scored in this series. It dates back to 1893.
Love you, Mom and Dad.
And all these 1988 records were back when I played, of course, Anthony Thompson. I'm afraid a lot of these are going to get broken. I know Alex Smith's eyeing them.
Jermaine Chaney from Flowery Branch, Georgia. 59-23 as we have 7 minutes 15 seconds left. O'Farrell hanging in there. Had his man Smith right on the numbers, but he dropped it. Last week against Florida, they had 8 drops. Their receivers had 8 drops, so a good indication right there there's lack of concentration.
There's Alex Smith, the man who had an incredible night. 225 yards.
In just 3 quarters.
Wow.
And Pacey with an excellent night for a quarterback on the ground, too, with 47.
Pacey's
out.
Pacey says, hey, let's head home.
Absolutely. 50-year senior will not lose at Kentucky in 94. O'Farrell. Has his man. Up to the 50-yard line.
Now, O'Farrell got the best of Pacey in high school. He won 2 of the games, and Pacey only won 1.
Well, Curtis has 1 touchdown tonight. That's been about the extent of his contribution. There he has. That's his 3rd draft. Yeah, David, why don't you go down on the field and see if you can grab Smith, the coach, right after the game. That'd be great.
Yeah, stay with us. We'll see if we can talk to those fellas about this big game.
Check you later.
Okay.
From the 49, a first for Kentucky. 6 minutes and 45 seconds remaining in the ball game. And O'Farrell handing off in the backfield to Gordon. Gordon up over the 50, down to the 45-yard line.
Now at this particular time, coach is really eyeing the defense. He knows it's a different unit, but he still wants them to do well and put that pressure on that quarterback and, of course, hold the line of scrimmage.
And the Hoosiers, obviously, a little bit excited about this one.
Adam Greenlee warming up.
That'll be the first time in a long time we've seen that happen. Go to the 3rd quarterback.
He's smiling. He knows he's getting in.
O'Farrell brings it down again.
Boy, he's quick.
He is very quick. And IU obviously playing the pass a lot here, too. Not looking so much for the run. Matt Surface gets his 2nd stop on the night here. Got 1 special teamer and then knocked this one down. Matt Surface from Marion. And faked the cameraman out, but O'Farrell brings it back down. And watch Matt stop.
Right there.
That's how you get him down.
So Kentucky has it on IU's 33-yard line, trailing 59-23 at the 5:44 mark in the 4th quarter. Not a very good pressure there. Almost an interception. Oh. Could have been twice almost an interception. And in and out of the arms of Smith. And Goody had it for a 2nd, too. He's already had his big number for the night almost at the outset of the ball game when he recovered that blocked punt. Watch it again right here. The intended receiver looked like it was Goody. And he's just playing center field out there as they're playing a zone.
I'm like, well, those walk-ons are tough, aren't they?
You definitely have a warm spot in your heart for a walk-on since you were Bill's first. O'Farrell again. And this time to the near sideline, has his man to the 20, down to the 19-yard line possibly. Let's see where they mark it. They'll mark it at the 21. And that's Woodford. Woodford, the backup fullback. Michael at 6'1", 208, a sophomore from Paducah. Here it comes right at you.
Indiana almost had an arm tackle here. You can't do that. You got to wrap him up.
Kentucky staying in the ball game with its big guys doing some pretty decent blocking here. No sacks for the Hoosiers. And Woodfork brings it down to the 21. Well, that was just a lousy pass, wasn't it, on the first half?
Kentucky's not giving up here. They want to put some more points on the board.
O'Farrell coming into this ball game is just 12 of 29 against Florida for 170 yards. He had rushed the ball 18 for 37, and he has fattened up his numbers for the contest here, but When he gets the big numbers, Kentucky is on the losing end of the scoreboard. Second and 10 from the 20-yard line, 59-23 IU. 5 minutes left in the ball game. Just kind of hanging around. He almost fell down on his own, but got it away. And Smith, he has a touchdown. Leon Smith, and that was a, excuse me, I have the touchdown.
I can't believe they didn't get a penalty. It looked like he spiked the ball. Well, Indiana's getting great pressure here. That's just unfortunate. They should have had him right there. He pops back out. Good balance.
Rudolph says, I'm open here. And he wanted him to move out a little bit. And that was tipped, wasn't it, by Ware?
Uh-huh.
Ware number
Smith
nine.
Smith takes the ball
IU.
And spikes it.
Well, I think the officials at this point aren't too concerned at 59-29. Watch Ware get the tip. Right there. And Smith the touchdown. Pretty good concentration for Smith to grab it on the tip.
I'm telling you, Coach Mallory right now, he's not happy. Even though he's got this large lead, he wants these players to all play well.
Well, on the basketball side, how many times have you seen Knight do that when they've been up by 30 points? He wants them to play for the entire time, and I think that's admirable. I think you ought to play the entire game, absolutely.
You got your future in some of these players. The young guys finally get out there and play, and of course, their turn's going to step up here in a couple years, or maybe even next year. So he wants to get them some practice time in.
Hey, folks, just a reminder, News Channel 13 at noon and News Channel 13 at 5 have each expanded to a full hour. What does that mean? Well, it means you'll see more news and information each week, 9:29, Indiana Advantage. And we would expect that Kentucky would try to go for a deuce here again. What the heck? Get as many points on the board as you can. Yeah, we were talking before, Joe, and I think the defensive coordinator for Kentucky is going to have a heart-to-heart with his ball players because getting blown out in two consecutive weeks is not fun.
It's tough. And their line of scrimmage, they got to do something up front because they're getting blown off the ball.
Fake pitch by O'Farrell. And he throws it out of the end zone.
Pretty good pressure.
He almost could have run that one
in.
I thought it was
a pass. We got him number three. Let's go Hoosiers.
He had to work once tonight, didn't he?
Well, he had the night off.
That's right. Hey, let's take a break here, and we'll be right back. 59-29 IU at 4:52 in the fourth.
See if they can get a mic check for me. Can you guys hear me?
Okay, is it somebody player of the game?
Alex Smith.
DuPont? I do have a card. Where are you, collect? 15 seconds. Welcome back to Commonwealth Stadium. Don Hein, Joe Huff, Dave Calabro. Tonight's DuPont Synchrony STS player of the game. Alex.
Great player, super individual. First time I met him was the first Mr. Indiana football award that they got.
Yeah, tell that story. That was great.
And I met Alex, and what a wonderful man. I looked up, but I did see him, and I'm like, well, this guy's the running back that everybody's talking about. I'm like, he doesn't look that threatening, but I'll tell you, I'd hate to play against him. I played against some good running backs, and I'll tell you, Alex is right there with him.
He's one of those guys that just as soon sting you as fake you out.
As Coach Mallard say, he honks her on in there.
Stay tuned, too, for our Chevrolet play of the game coming up in just a little bit.
Don, I think we're going to have an onside kick here.
I would guess so. At this point, at 59-29, it's not going to hurt him. Wow.
Kicked it away.
They
recover that.
Let it go out of bounds and get it at the, penalty on Kentucky for not keeping it in bounds.
That kick.
That's really repressive in the pros. You get it at the 45-yard line. This is, as we said, Greenlee's first collegiate appearance from Columbus, Ohio. Right on the 35 in collegiate football, so that's where we'll take off.
I'll tell you, Adam is a great quarterback, too. For being a third-string quarterback, Indiana has to be happy with their quarterback situation.
All right, the Hoosiers have it from the 35-yard line. And have 4 minutes and 51 seconds left to go in the contest, or the lack thereof. Well, I'm going to have go to the other one, too, because we don't have third-string backfield either. Okay, David, take it down there, and we'll check him out.
All right, Don, here's our player of the game, Alex Smith. And, Alex, I just want to quickly say hello to you. The folks at home are watching, and you've been named the player of the game. Your line did a heck of a job tonight.
Oh, yeah, they're opening some great holes, and we're just out there running and having fun.
You guys blew this thing open early on with the running game. They could not stop you.
Well, I felt like, you know, after we blocked that punt, and that was a big play, and we had the momentum going, and we came out fired up, and we just got the ball in the red zone and put it in.
What does this mean, you guys, to be up 59-29 with 4 minutes to go at Kentucky, and nobody's here except for the IU fan?
Well, that's a lot of fun. This is what we come down to do, and just glad that we got it done tonight.
And you guys have set a school record for rushing tonight. Congratulations to you and your line. Don, we'll send it back to you. The Hoosiers are happy. We'll have more in a bit.
Okay, nice job, David. Back up top again, and you're going to see a lot of young men that you haven't seen before. Adam Greenlee, we've talked about. And there he is from Columbus, Indiana. 6'2", 190, and a junior.
31.
Now we're going to the deuce backfield this time around. And the official says...
Adam wanted to get that throw in.
Yeah, they ran out of time on the clock here.
He wanted to get that throw in. So it's going to be a fun bus ride home.
There aren't too many fun bus rides, are there, huh? All right. I can remember in college riding to North Dakota a few times, and that was not fun at all. All right.
Get pounced on and take a three-hour trip or drive home. It's not the funnest thing in the world, Don.
That is true. And Kentucky just trying to make it to the end of this one right here. What do you bet that Greenlee wants to get this one in the air this time?
There he goes.
And he has his man, too, at the 50-yard line. That's going to be enough for the first down for the Hoosiers.
I tell you, he rifled that one. He looked good on that play.
Ben Davis, Brian Bruner on the catch. Yeah. Bruner getting some full-time duty tonight. He was going with the first and second unit, and now he's going with the guys that are mopping up here.
Again, the offensive line just dominating, giving Adams free time to throw that ball.
First from the 48 for Indiana, leading 59-29 with 2 minutes and 51 seconds remaining in the ball game. And this time we have the hand again to the near side across the 40 down to the 37-yard line. David, take it off down there with Brett. Now we're having a little audio problem there, David.
It's good to get this win under our belt and get the Big Ten season started.
I think we had a little audio problem there. Happy birthday once again to you, and congratulations on a 100-yard game tonight.
Thank you. It's good to get the win under our belt, start the Big Ten Conference next week. You know, the big game against Wisconsin, we travel up to Madison, and we got to get the job done.
Did you expect to see your line dominate the line of scrimmage like that tonight?
I'll tell you, our line's done a heck of a job all season long, and yeah, I really did. I mean, those guys have been doing a hell of a job as years progressed, and hopefully they just keep gelling.
And I'm supposed to tell everybody in Bloomington that there's a big party tonight. Is that right?
Yeah, well, we can manage one.
All right. Don, we'll send him back to you up in the booth.
Okay, David Olverson on the carry there, number 20. And the Hoosiers changing at will. You could not find an unhappy Hoosier on this sideline, I'll tell you that. 59-29, Indiana. Ball's on the 25, and we have just a minute 55 remaining in the ball game. Olverson again right up the gut, over the 25, down to the 22-yard line. Well, our play of the game, there were so many plays of the game, but we're going to choose for the Synchrony SDS DuPont Peanut. The 63-yard run by Alex Smith. 225 yards on the night, and 63 of them chewed off right there. 563 yards for the Hoosiers in offense this evening. Man, oh man. Nice job, by the way, Bob Bernath. Pretty nicely done.
Right now, Don, Indiana's not trying to score. Bill really wants to run this clock down. You know, you want to let these guys out his way.
And Todd Starwitz doing our picking tonight of players who were tackled and blocked. Nice job, Todd. Thank you very much. And a nice crew here, too, with a six-camera show. And Joe Dillon up there in Chopper 13. Beauteous pictures tonight. As the clock runs down, 46-45. And this is the way this one's going to end, with a third and three from the 18 for Indiana. And folks, we're about the only ones left here, with the exception of all those folks in red on the far side.
Well, Don, I hope the viewers stay tuned, because we have a former graduate of Indiana University and Tiffany Storm for the pageant coming up next.
As a matter of fact, she won the swimsuit competition, didn't she?
Alumni.
Right.
She's got a, from what I understand, she's got an excellent chance.
Well, we wish her the very best of luck, and that comes up next here on Channel 13. Well, tonight's Ameritech best call of the game, right here, courtesy Ameritech, and here it comes at you. This is the Pacey option. He called his own number and says, I can handle this one, guys. Right in your face. Give me a little room to run, and I'll take that turkey in for six. There it is. John Pacey with the touchdown. Indiana offense tonight.
IU fans, if you want to take a shot from over there, as they celebrate a fantastic win here tonight, 59-29. They've only won one out of six tries here. So the Indiana Hoosiers celebrating on the other side of the field right now. Don will try to get Coach Mallory into pull back up you for now. We'll try to grab him and have him momentarily.
Do scream when you do. 59-29 our score. Let's take a break and then we'll be back to talk to you. Oh, no break. Let's stay right here. All right. Fellowship of Christian Athletes in the middle of the field right here. They were bombed pretty much tonight, thanking the Lord, obviously, that they were not injured. 566 rushing yards and passing yards for 86, 674 total. Unbelievable. Now they want me to go to break at that.
At Indiana, the Hoosiers have a trio of talent.